इसलिए श्रील भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी गोस्वामी महाराज क्या कहते थे, वो कहते थे जब भगवान राम आए तभी भी हम भक्त थे, उसी समय भी वही, जब भगवान कृष्ण आए तभी हम भी वही, जब श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु आए तभी भी हम वही, लेकिन जब श्री शरद स्वामी आए तभी भी हम वही, लेकिन हम जैसे प्रतीक व्यक्ति के ऊपर में किसी ने अभी तक कृपा नहीं की। अगर हमारे ऊपर में अगर कोई कृपा की तो हमारी चोटी पकड़ करके अगर कोई संसार में नरक से निकाले तो किसी ने हमें निकाले बोले श्री गुरुदेव ही निकाले, इसलिए हम लोग श्री गुरु जी के चरण में बहुत बहुत
that when Lord Ram and Ram incarnated on this planet, then we must have been there, we were there. When Lord Krishna incarnated, then also we were there. Mahaprabhu came, then also we were there. The six Goswamis came, then also we were there. But nobody pulled us out from this material existence. It was only by the desire, by the efforts of Gurudev, or our Gurudev, that he has pulled us out of this material existence. So because of this, we are eternally and very, very indebted to our Gurudev.
वो कहते थे बोले पुरी से कीट है ते मुनि से लघिष्ठ, जगाई माथाई है ते मुनि से पापिष्ठ, मोर नाम लय दे तार पाप है, मेरा नाम सुने दे तार पुण्य है, हेमन निर्घिन मरे केवा विचारे एक गुरु पाद पद्म बिना संसार माता है। कहते थे कहते जगाई माथाई है ते मुनि से पापिष्ठ, कहते जगाई माथाई से बड़ा पापिष्ठ जगत में कोई नहीं हो सकता, इतने बड़े पापी। जब जमदूत या करके चित्रगुप्त को बोलते थे आज जगाई माता ने ये किया वो किया वो किया वो किया, इसको सुन सुन करके चित्रगुप्त को इतने क्रोध आता था, मतलब कभी ऐसे हो सकता है दो पाप इतने पाप कर सकते हैं, लिखते 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 गोडाउन भरे गए। अब वो सोच रहे थे इतने बड़े पापी को उधार गए इसे पता नहीं कितनी काल तक इनको ये नरक भोगना पड़ेगा, है कितने काम तक, इसलिए कहते हैं उनसे भी ज्यादा पापिष्ट अगर मैं हूँ और पूरी शरीर कीट है तो नीचे लगिष्ठा, मतलब विष्ठा का कीड़े जो होते हैं उससे भी मैं गया रहता हूँ, अगर मेरे कोई नाम ले ले तो उसका पुण्य खत्म हो जाता है, मेरे नाम को कोई सुन ले तो उसका पाप होता है, पर इतने हम निकृष्ट है देखिए ऐसे पापी को अगर उधार करने वाले हो तो कौन है वो श्री गुरुपाद करो, क्योंकि गुरुदेव नित्यानंद अभिन्न श्री गुरुदेव, इसलिए अगर ऐसे पापी को भी उधार करेगा तो श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु गुरुपाद कर ही हमें उधार किया, इसलिए हम सबके सब गुरु के चरण में सबके सब हम रहे हैं।
When the Yamadutas they used to go to Yamaraj, because that in those description of the times when Jagai and Madhai were on this planet, and the Yamadutas they would go to Chitragupta, the accountant of Yamaraj, then they would tell him that, oh, this is what the Jagai and Madhai, the most fallen people on this planet, they have done such an activity today. And then Chitragupta would become very frustrated and very angry at this, because he said, you are every day you are bringing me so many accounts of their misdeeds, of so many sinful activities they have performed. For me, I can't believe it that some one person can perform so many simple activities. And then he was describing that there are the accounts that he was keeping on Jagai and Madai, the accounts, books, you were full, one full godown was full of the keeping their accounts, and it was so many simple activities they have performed. And that Chitragupta used to say that I don't know for all these simple activities how much they will have to suffer and how many cow they will have to suffer. So, Maharaj used to describe that I am more fallen than them. I am even more fallen than what is my condition, and I am the I am lower than the worm in the stool. And he's saying that I am so sinful that if somebody chants my name, if somebody takes my name, is all the auspicious results are finished. And if somebody chants my name, it is he gets he accrues sinful reactions. He's saying such persons as we are, who had the power, who had the strength to free us from all this sinful activity, who had the power to take us from this material existence. He is describing that it was only our Gurudev, who is non different from Nityanand Prabhu. It was only He, by His mercy, that we have been liberated from this situation, and we are performing these devotional activities, whatever little devotional activities we are performing. So understand, because of this, that Gurudev has performed such a wonderful task for us, we eternally remain indebted to Him.
इसलिए गुरु जी की जो महिमा है, कहते गुरु जी की महिमा अपरंत गुरु जी का महिमा। इसलिए एक शास्त्र ने बताया, बोले ध्यानम मूलम गुरु मंत्रम, पूजा मूलम गुरु पद, मोक्ष मूलम गुरु वाक्य, मुक्ति मूलम गुरु पद। वहां पर श्लोक में बताया ध्यान मूलम गुरु पद। बल जगत में बहुत सारे ध्यान है, लेकिन ध्यान में जो मूल जो क्या है, बोले गुरु का पाद पद्म। इसलिए कृष्ण भागवत में कहते हैं, प्रथमंतु गुरुं पूज्यं ततश्चैव ममाचरणं कुर्वन् सिद्धिमाप्नोति जनता निष्फलं। कृष्ण कहते हैं, उद्धव पहले गुरु जी की प्रणाम करते हुए, गुरु जी की पूजा करते हुए उसको बाद में मेरी पूजा करनी चाहिए। अगर जो व्यक्ति गुरु जी की पूजा के बगैर और डायरेक्ट अगर पूजा करता है, उसका जितने पूजा करते सब निष्फल हो जाता है, पूजा करने का कोई फल नहीं मिलता। इसलिए हमारे मंदिर में दो चरणामृत रहता है, दो जगह में चरणामृत रहती है, चरणामृत कहते हैं, एक गुरु जी की और एक ठाकुर जी की। क्योंकि नियम है, ठाकुर जी की पूजा करने से पहले गुरु जी की पहले चरण पूजा करना पड़ता है, उसके बाद में जाकर के कृष्ण पूजा होता है। इसलिए कहते गुरु छाड़ी गोविंद भजे इससे काफी दर्द में, जो गुरुदेव को छोड़ करके गोविंद को भजन करता है, कहते से पापी नरक मजे, तो नरक भोगना पड़ता है। इसलिए यहाँ पर बताए भगवान कहते हैं, सिद्धिर भगवति वाले की संशय अच्युत सेवना, कहते जो डायरेक्ट मेरी सेवा पूजा करता है, मैं कोई गैप नहीं दे सकता हूँ, वो मेरे को प्राप्त करेगा। संशय चत्र तद भक्त परिचर जागरता, लेकिन जो गुरु जी की चरण की पूजा वंदना करता है, सेवा करता है, भगवान कहते हैं वो निसंशय, मतलब उसमें कोई शंका नहीं, मुझको प्राप्त करने के लिए वो जरूर मुझे प्राप्त करेगा। इसलिए बोले ध्यान मूलम गुरु पद, जो ध्यान का जो मूल क्या है, जैसे गुरु जी की चरण है।
So he is describing that in Srimad Bhagavatam further it is said that the basis of dhyan, of meditation. Dhyan Mulam Guru Pada. He is saying that this is from some Puran that it is describing. That the basis of all meditation, or the topmost or the center of all meditations, is meditating on Gurudev. Describing in the dialogues between Uddhav and Krishna, it is described that Krishna is saying that you have to, first of all, you have to perform worship, you have to pay obeisances to your Gurudev, and then you have to pay obeisances to me. Suppose he's saying, also he's saying further that suppose somebody is performing his worship to me without worshipping his Gurudev, he's saying all such worship is useless. All such worship is completely, it will not accrue any result. Further it is said in Srimad Bhagavatam, that if suppose somebody neglects his Gurudev, and worships me, he will have to go to death.
Even Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yeah,
This is Bhaktivinoda Thakur's Kirtan, that he's saying that suppose somebody worships me and directly and does not worship Gurudev, then understand that he will have to go to hell.
So scripture directly, you know, if somebody direct their worship to Krishna, I cannot get to guarantee once he can attend to me. But who is the worship to my devotee, I can get to guarantee once he must attend to me.
Yeah.
कहते पूजा का जो मूल क्या है, बल्कि गुरु जी की चरण कमल है, इसलिए और कहते वाक्य मूलम गुरु वाक्य, कहते जो मंत्र मूलम गुरु वाक्य, इसका मतलब गुरुदेव ने जो बोल दिया उसको हृदय बोले गुरु मुख पद्म वाक्य चिंते ते करिया कहित आर ना करित मान आस, है ना। नरोत्तम दास ठाकुर कहते हैं गुरुदेव ने जो कुछ बोल दिया वही सब कुछ है, इसलिए गुरुदेव के वाक्यों के ऊपर विश्वास करते हुए सब कुछ गुरु जी के, और इसलिए कहते गुरु सब कुछ गुरुदेव है, गुरुदेव का चरण को छोड़कर जगत में और कुछ है नहीं, सब कुछ गुरु की कृपा है।
So he's describing that everything that is there in the world, actually it is the mercy of Gurudev. He's describing that how the center or the basis of all meditation or the center of all meditation should be our meditation on Gurudev. Gurudev's words is considered to be the center or basis of all Vedas. He is not different from the Lord himself. Understand, whatever you are meditating, whatever worship you are performing, whatever words he speaks should be the center of your life. You should adopt that as the very center or the basis of all the learnings that you are learning.
At the same time, Bhagavan Krishna, sare Ved, Puran, Upanishad, sare granta ko ek din Bhagavan ne bulaya. Bula kare Bhagavan ne ek prashna diya. Bole mere prashna ka uttar do. Bhagavan ka prashna hai. Bhagavat prapti ka sabse saral upay kya hai? भक्ति पाने का सबसे सरल उपाय क्या, भगवत प्राप्ति भक्ति पाने का। उन्होंने सारे ग्रंथों को उन्होंने प्रश्न की, उन्होंने वेद को खड़े किया, हमें बताओ भगवत प्राप्ति का सबसे सरल उपाय क्या है। तो उन्होंने वेद में बताया तब विष्णु परम पदम सदा पश्चंती सूर्य, कहते भगवान के चरण कमल को ध्यान पूजा भक्ति करनी चाहिए। उन्होंने वेद में बड़ी बड़ी मंत्र को उच्चारण किया, लेकिन भगवान ने बोले भैया मेरे को तुम्हारी प्रश्न में आंसर में मेरे को सैटिस्फाई नहीं हुआ, तुम बैठ जा। फिर उन्होंने उपनिषदों को बुलाया, बोले तुम बताओ। तो उन्होंने बोले साफ परानुरक्ति ईश्वर, भगवान के प्रति श्रेष्ठ अनुरक्ति रखनी चाहिए, जैसे उद्धव नारदा से किया है। वो भी बड़े बड़े श्लोकों को उच्चारण किया, लेकिन भगवान बोले मेरे को संतुष्ट नहीं हुआ, तुम बैठ जा। फिर उन्होंने उपनिषदों को, फिर उन्होंने खड़े किया ब्रह्म सूत्र को, तो ब्रह्म सूत्र ने बताया अर्थात ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा शास्त्र जनित अनावृत शब्दा अनावृत शब्द, भगवान का नाम जप करो, भगवत आराधना करो, भक्ति करो। उन्होंने बड़े बड़े लेक्चर दिया, लेकिन भगवान को बड़े संतुष्ट नहीं हुआ। उन्होंने जितने पुराण को खड़ी किए, गीता को भी खड़ी की, बोले तुम बताओ। गीता बताया सर्वधर्मान पर त्यज माम एक शरण व्रज आम त्वाम सर्व पावी भगवत मन मना भव मद भक्त भव माम जय माम नमस्कार, सब कुछ भगवान के लिए करो, सब छोड़ दे। लेकिन भगवान बोले मैं जिस चीज को सुनना चाहता हूँ तो मेरे सही सही उत्तर नहीं, सारे शास्त्र तो आश्चर्य में रहेंगे, हम इतनी इतनी अच्छी अच्छी बात बताए और भगवान हमें रिजेक्ट करके हम खुश नहीं। लेकिन अभी केवल एक भागवत ग्रंथ लास्ट में रह गया है, अभी भगवान उसको प्रश्न करेगा।
So he was saying that one time the Lord called all the scriptures, the Vedas, the Upanishads, all the scriptures he called, and he is wanting to ask them a question. He raised them a question, all of them. And he is asking this question that, please tell me, what is the sure shot way of attaining at the Lord? Sure shot method of attaining perfection and devotion. So first of all, he asked the Vedas. And the Vedas quoted so many shlokas that how you should meditate on the Lord. And then he asked the Lord, and he quoted so many shlokas he quoted describing, but the Lord said, I'm not satisfied with this. Then he raised the Upanishad, he asked the same question to the Upanishad. Upanishad also said that you should put the Supreme Lord as the Supreme, and you should worship as the Supreme, and you should meditate on Him. And he also quoted so many shlokas, etc. from Upanishads. And then like this, the Puranas and other scriptures were asked so many questions. Then they said that, Brahma-jigyasa, etc. They said that, oh, you should already be inquisitive about the Lord, about the Supreme. And Bhagavad Gita was also asked this question. It said that, Sat-Bhamman Paritajya, Mamekum Shannavela, and like this, it quoted many shlokas, etc. But the Lord is saying that, although everybody has given very scholarly answers, but still I am not satisfied by all the answers that you have given. What I want to really hear, that I have not heard from anyone yet. So when all the scriptures heard this, they were surprised that we have given such wonderful quotations of different shastra, but still the Lord is not satisfied. But still one scripture is left there, which is not asked this question, the Srimad Bhagavatam. And then he asked the same question of Srimad Bhagavatam. What does Srimad Bhagavatam say now?
हमने दो श्लोक उठा कर उन्होंने इसका आंसर दिया कहते एक श्लोक है जब श्री प्रह्लाद महाराज को उसको पिताजी ने जो प्रश्न की बताओ तेरे गुरुजी ने तुमको क्या शिक्षा दी है जितने शिक्षा में सर्वश्रेष्ठ शिक्षा दिया है जब उन्होंने ये प्रश्न की तब श्री प्रह्लाद महाराज ने जो उत्तर दिया था हैं श्रवणम कीर्तनम विष्णु स्मरणम पाद सदनम अर्चनम बंदनम दास्य सख्या जब उन्होंने उत्तर उन्होंने दिए इसके उत्तर को सुन करके इतने में ही हिरण्यकश्यप ने कहा तेरे बुद्धि को किसने बिगाड़ दिया है ये संध्या वर्कर जिस गुरु जी के पास में हम तुमको भेजा था पढ़ाई लिखाई के लिए क्या ये संध्या हमारे तुम्हारे बुद्धि को बिगाड़ दिया है तो उसी समय में श्री प्रह्लाद महाराज कहते तो बोले पिताजी अनर्थ अपगमम जदर्थ श्लोक उच्चारण इसका मतलब है पिताजी आप कह रहे हो ये मति ये संध्या अमर के ने हमारी भगवत चरण में लगा दी और जिसका स्वयं मति ठाकुर जी के चरण में लगाई दी कहते उसकी उपदेश से हमारी मति कैसे भगवान चरण में लग जाएगी हाँ संध्या वर्त
इसकी मति नहीं लगी हुई
संध्या वर्त का मति स्वयं मति में लगाई नहीं वो फिर हमारी मति को कैसे भगवत चरण में लगा सकती है इसलिए कहते तब कहते मही असाम निष्किंचना नाम न प्रणित जावत कहते जब तक हम लोग किसी निष्किंचन भगवत भक्तों को चरण में हम शरणागत नहीं होते जो कुछ क्यों नहीं कर ले ये मति इसी तरह से भगवत चरण में लगी नहीं सकती इसलिए लगाने के लिए कोई महापुरुष होनी चाहिए कोई महान साधु चरण में हमें शरणागति होना पड़ेगा तो उन्होंने ये एक श्लोक प्रसन्न किया दूसरे श्लोक उन्होंने बताए जब श्री रहुगण महाराज को श्री जड़ भरत ने बताया बोले रहुगण ही न तपस्या न जाति न इज्जया निर्पापनात् गृहात्वा नैव छन्दसा नैव जलाग्नि बिना महत पदो रजो विषयः जीवन में जो कुछ कर लो रहुगण ही न तपस्या बोले तपस्या से भगवत प्राप्त नहीं होता है पूजा को द्वारा नहीं होता वेद पढ़ने पर नहीं होता घर छोड़ने पर नहीं होता जल अग्नि की पूजा करने पर नहीं होता बोले कब होता है जब तक किसी सदगुरु को शरण में किसी शुद्ध वैष्णव का शरण में जब तक नहीं जाओ भले ही जीवन में जो कुछ कर लो ये मति किसी तरह से भगवत चरण में लग नहीं सकता जब उन्होंने ये दो श्लोक को बताए कृष्ण प्रसन्न हो बोले हाँ मैं यही चाह रहा था यही सुनने के लिए चाह रहा था जब तक भक्तों की कृपा नहीं हो गुरु जी की कृपा नहीं हो तब तक ये मति कभी किसी तरह से भगवत चरण में
So, when the same question was raised to Srimad Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam he quoted two shlokas. One shloka is from when Prahlad Maharaj is being asked by his father Hiranyakashipu. He's being asked this question that what have you learned, all that you have spent so much time in this school? And learning from your teachers, Shanda and Amar, what have you learned? Then what is the topmost learning that you have learned in this school? That time he said,
Saravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada, Sevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasa, Sakya, Atmanivedanam.
So when he quoted this shloka, then Hiranyakashipu was asking that, who has spoiled your brain? Who has spoiled you? Where have you learned this from? Is it Shanda Amar, your teachers, who have spoiled this brain? Then again, he's quoting another stroke. Srimad Bhagavatam is quoting another stroke. Prahlad Maharaj is quoting the stroke. He's saying that those Shanda Amar, means you are telling my teachers have spoiled my brain and they have given me this lesson of the Shravan Kirtan, etc. He said, but those who themselves, their brains are not absorbed in devotional activities, how can they teach me these things? It is not possible. Unless and until a person does not surrender, a person does not learn from some realized soul, he will never come to understand this. And then second shlok that Srimad Bhagavatam quoted was between the dialogues between Draupadi Maharaj and Jada Maharaj. Jada Maharaj is telling to Draupadi Maharaj, he's saying that a person may perform so many activities in the world for as so-called devotional practices. Like he may leave the home, he may perform yajna, he may perform tapas, austerities, he may read the scriptures, he may do so many things. But unless and until one does not surrender to a realized soul, somebody who has realized the Supreme Lord, unless and until he does not surrender, he will never be able to progress in spiritual life. He will never get any result in spiritual life. So that's why by hearing these two shlokas, these two quotations, these two quotes of these two shlokas, Krishna asking these questions became very happy. He said, this is what I was looking for and now I'm completely satisfied by this answer.
आज से गुरुजी की जन्म तिथि है, गुरुजी की आज जन्म तिथि है, इसका मतलब है जब तक जीव सदगुरु की शरण में हो, कहते साधारण व्यक्ति की बात छोड़ दो, कहते ब्रह्मा शंकर जैसे बन जाए, ब्रह्मा शंकर का भी गुरु है, ब्रह्मा के भी गुरु है, शंकर जी का भी गुरु है, कहते इनके जैसे अगर दुनिया में कोई बराबर बन जाए और कोई सदगुरु का चरण आश्रय नहीं करे उधार श्री राधा नंद बिहारी जो की जय, श्री गुरुपाद पद्म की जय, पिताई गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल गोपाल प्रभु की जय,
रघुनंद स्वामी की
जय, जगन्नाथ महाप्रभु की
जय। किसने बोली है
वो स्वामी तुलसी ने सो
Goswami Tulsi Das is describing that unless and until Goswami Tulsi Das is describing that maybe somebody might be as exalted a personality as Brahma or Shankar, but still, so, till one does not surrender, till does not one does not take the instructions from a bona fide guru, he will never be able to attain realize the Supreme Lord. So today is our Gurudev's appearance day. Understand that we must surrender to such a bona fide guru completely so that we can attain success in our devotional activities.
इसलिए कहते आज से व्यास पूजा है, कहते हैं प्रश्न है इसको व्यास पूजा क्यों कहते हैं, कहते व्यास पूजा तो जो व्यास देव का जो आविर्भाव है, हैं कहते व्यास देव का आविर्भाव को हम व्यास पूजा कहते हैं, फिर आज इसको फिर हम व्यास पूजा क्यों कहते हैं, इसलिए इसलिए प्रभुपाद कहते हैं कहते व्यास का मतलब होता है विस्तार करना, विस्तार करना, इसलिए वेद व्यास नहीं, कैसे एक वेद को उन्होंने विस्तार करके चार वेद बनाए, फिर कैसे उन्होंने ब्रह्म सूत्र को रचना की, उपनिषद को रचना की, 18 पूर्ण को रचना की, फिर पंचम वेद श्री महाभारत को रचना की, और लास्ट में उन्होंने ये श्रीमद भागवत ग्रंथों को रचना करते हैं, कौन श्री व्यास देव जी, व्यास मतलब होता है विस्तार करना, इसको कहते हैं व्यास है, कहते व्यास देव ने जो काम की थी अभी हमारे गुरुपाद पद्म जी उसी पोस्ट में बैठ करके क्या कर रहे हैं, उनका ही काम को लेकर रहे हैं, क्या कर रहे हैं, सारे शास्त्र ग्रंथों को विस्तार करते हुए संपूर्ण विश्व में भगवान की वाणी को प्रचार करते हैं, इसलिए हम अपना गुरु जी को भी, गुरु जी की जन्मतिथि को भी हम व्यास पूजा बोलकर हम भी पूजा करते हैं।
So today is the Vyas Puja of our Gurudev, and somebody may ask this question that why is there the appearance day of our Gurudev is called Vyas Puja? Because Vyas Puja should be considered that day when Vyasadeva himself appeared on this planet. To understand this, you must understand that what does the word meaning Vyas is that Vyas means to expand. Vyasadeva also when he was here, he expanded. First he expanded the one that used to be existing only just one way, then he expanded to four, then he created Upanishads, then he wrote so many other scriptures, then he Pancham Ved, Mahabharata also he wrote. He wrote all this means he's expanded. The task that Vyasadeva is performing or Vyasadeva performed, our Gurudev also in his position when he comes here, he also is expanding. he is expanding the scriptures, explaining the scriptures more deeply, explaining the scriptures more elaborately. This is the task of Vyasadeva, and this is what exactly what Gurudev is doing. So that is why Gurudev's appearance there is also called Vyasa Puja.
Srila Prabhupada kehte hain kya Vyasa Puja ka matlab kya hai? Hamare Bharat mein log kya kehte hain? Jis din Vyasa Puja hota hai, हर व्यक्ति गुरु जी को पूजा करने के लिए आते हैं हर बात में। और जैसे कुछ कपड़ा लेकर के आते हैं, कुछ प्रणाम लेकर के आते हैं, कुछ फूल माला फल, इसको हर शिष्य व्यास पूजा करते हैं, कुछ लेकर के गुरु जी की शरण में आते हैं और गुरु जी को देते हैं। हमारे भारत में ये सब चीज़ें होती हैं। श्री प्रभुपाद कहते हैं भैया व्यास पूजा का मतलब क्या, यही है कुछ प्रणाम ला कर गुरु को दे दो, थोड़ी कपड़ा लगा और फूल की माला दे दो, यही क्या व्यास पूजा हो गया? प्रभुपाद कहते हैं जिसको व्यास पूजा नहीं कहते, कहते व्यास पूजा उसको कहते हैं जिसकी है अगर शिष्य, अगर शिष्य गुरुदेव का जो आदर्श है, गुरुदेव का जो भजन पद्धति है, अगर यह चीज को अगर अपना जीवन में अपनाया पाया तो तभी इसको व्यास पूजा कहते हैं। थोड़ा फूल पैसा ला कर गुरुदेव को दे देना, इसको व्यास पूजा नहीं कहते। तो उपचार करनी चाहिए लेकिन ये व्यास पूजा नहीं। व्यास पूजा का मतलब है गुरुदेव जो चाहते हैं। बोले भैया गुरुदेव क्या चाहते हैं, गुरुदेव का क्या इच्छा है? बोले गुरुदेव की दो इच्छा है। गुरुदेव का एक इच्छा है, कहती गुरुदेव है कौन, गुरुदेव कौन है? इसलिए सर विश्वनाथ चतुर ठाकुर कहते हैं बोले संसार का त्राणाय कारुण्या घनाघनात्वं प्राप्तस्य कल्याणं गोणार्णवस्य वन्दे गुरवश्री चरणारविन्दम्। इसलिए विश्वनाथ चतुर्थ ठाकुर कहते गुरुजी कौन है? बोले गुरुजी भगवान की जो कृपा ही एक रोटी धारण करता है। गुरु जी कर जीव का दुख कष्ट को देख करके भगवान की कृपा ही एक मूर्ति बन करके इस जगत में आते हैं। बोले क्यों? बोले त्राणाय कारुण्य घनात्वं, ये जीव को उद्धार करने के लिए गुरुपाद पद्म इस जगत में आते हैं। इसलिए गुरु जी की एक इच्छा है एक जीव को संसार के बंधन से उसको निकाल करके हम कैसे भगवान के पास में ले जाए, ये गुरु जी की इच्छा है, हैं? इसलिए जिस समय ध्रुव महाराज वैकुंठ विजय कर रहे थे उसी समय से नारद जी बिना बजा बजा करके जोर जोर से कीर्तन कर रहे थे, बड़े खुश हो गए। बोले क्यों? बोले आज हमने एक जीव को ये संसार से निकाल करके भगवान का चरण में ले जा रहे हैं, बड़े प्रसन्न हो रहे थे बिना बजा बजा करके। इसलिए गुरु जी की ये एक इच्छा है जीव के संसार से निकाल, ये एक इच्छा। बोले दूसरी इच्छा क्या है? बोले श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टम स्थापितम जैन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति सुखदाय। इसलिए गुरु जी दूसरी इच्छा है महाप्रभु का जो वाणी है ये पृथ्वी में महाप्रभु का वाणी प्रचार हो, पृथ्वी के आश्रित नगर आदि ग्राम सर्वत्र प्रचार है, ये गुरु जी की इच्छा है। कभी ये दो इच्छा जो पूर्ण कर लेता है तो उसकी ही असल रूप में गुरु पूजा उसकी होती है।
So he is describing further that Srila Bhakti Sanskriti Prabhupada, he used to say that what is real Vyasa Puja and how the Vyasa Puja should, how Vyasa Puja should be celebrated. If you go in India, you will see the usual process of celebrating Vyasa Puja is that all the disciples of Gurudev, they bring something for Gurudev. They bring a maybe flower garland, maybe they bring some cloth, maybe they bring some other gift for Gurudev, and they bring this to Gurudev and they offer to Gurudev. So Srila Sanskriti Prabhupada is asking, so after making some offerings, such offerings to Gurudev, is the Vyasa Puja complete? He's saying no. This is Vyasa Puja. Yes, this is a formality that you should complete, you should bring some gifts according to your capacity, you should bring some gifts. But what is the real Vyasa Puja? The real Vyasa Puja is that the day when you, whatever Gurudev has taught you, whatever Gurudev has spoken to you, whatever Gurudev instructions he has given to you, the day you adopt these teachings in your life, the day that Gurudev, whatever process of devotional activities he has given you, the day you adopt those activities in your life, That is understand that that is real offering, that is real Vyasa Puja. And further, what is Gurudev? What is that Gurudev? So Vishwanath Thakur is describing that. What is the desire of Gurudev? Gurudev has two desires. Gurudev has two desires. One is that he wants that Gurudev wants that all the living entities should become free from this material entanglement. It is described that when Dhruva Maharaj, it's described that when Dhruva Maharaj, he was crossing over this material resistance, taken in an airplane to Vaikuntha Loka. That time, Narada Muni, on his veena, the string instrument, he's singing and dancing loudly in the sky when he's seeing Dhruva Maharaj go away from the material resistance to Vaikuntha Loka. Why? Because he was so happy. He was thinking, oh, this is one jiva, one living entity whom I have freed from the Shri Chaitanya Mahavishnu Sthapitam Yen Bhutale. Means he also has come here to establish the teachings and the instructions of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he has come here to establish this. And this is one of the desires to establish this. And who is Gurudev? He described in the verse of Srila Vishnu Thakur, Gurudev is somebody, Samsara Dava Nala Lila Loka, Ranayam Dhanayam Dhanatma. He's saying, Tarana Karunya Dhanadharatma means when the Lord's mercy takes on a form, that is Gurudev. So that is Gurudev, and he is the personification or embodiment of the Lord's mercy, and that is why he has come as to free from this world and establish Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission to form this
planet. हाँ, कहते सारे कपटता को छोड़ करके निष्कपट होकर के भगवान के हमें भक्ति करनी चाहिए। कहते ये गुरु की इच्छा है, निष्कपट होकर के भगवान की भक्ति करो। ये एक चीज है। दूसरी ये क्या है, दुनिया में भगवत कथा को प्रचार करनी चाहिए। इसलिए दो काम है, एक तो भक्ति करना और पृथ्वी में महाप्रभु का वाणी को प्रचार करना। कहते यही असली व्यास पूजा, आज का भी व्यास पूजा है। ये काम को जो जितने कर पाएगा समझना व्यास पूजा उसकी उतना परिमाण व्यास पूजा है।
So he is describing that what is real Vyas Puja, celebration of real Vyas Puja. Understand that one who can adopt the teachings of his Gurudev in his life, that is one,
without duplicity,
one adopts the teachings of the Gurudev in his life. Understand that is one part of the Vyas Puja. And the other part is to preach whatever you have learned from Gurudev all over the planet according to your capacity, however you can. Understand this is another part of the Vyas Puja. So one who is able to adopt the teachings and one who is able to perform the devotional activities without duplicity according to the instructions of Gurudev, and who is able to preach, who is preaching, where whoever will do whatever extent today, understand his Vyas Puja is successful.
So this is the Mahaprabhu desire. What is the Mahaprabhu desire? Coming one is such a day, whole world become Krishna consciousness, you know. Everybody chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. व्यास पूजा को सर्वप्रथम किसने आरंभ की है? हैं? करिए श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु ने सर्वप्रथम व्यास पूजा को आरंभ किया है। बल्कि जिस समय व्यास देव का कल उनकी जन्मतिथि, महाप्रभु जब नवद्वीप में रहते थे, महाप्रभु ने कल कहा, देखो कल व्यास पूजा है, व्यास देव का जन्मतिथि है, कल हम सबके सब व्यास पूजा मनाएंगे। बोले कहाँ पर मनाएंगे? बोले श्रीवास आंगन में। श्रीवास आंगन में श्रीवास को करने हम व्यास पूजा मनाएंगे। महाप्रभु श्रीवास पंडित गुरु बोले, कल हम व्यास पूजा बनाएंगे तेरे घर में, बहुत सब दर्शन करेंगे, व्यास पूजा दर्शन करेंगे। हाँ, थोड़ी सी पान सुपारी और पूजा की सामग्री, फूल चंदन थोड़ा ले आएंगे, ठाकुर की इच्छा से सब कुछ घर में है। बड़े भाग्य है, कल से व्यास पूजा हम लोग महोत्सव दर्शन करेंगे। सबके सब श्री श्रीवास पंडित के घर में सबके सब पहुंचे। जब पहुंचे सारे धूप चंदन अगुर कर्पूर सब कुछ लेकर के वहां पर सबके सब पहुंचे। अभी एक समय होता है ना शुभ तिथि होता है जिस तिथि में सिर्फ व्यास देव की पूजा करनी चाहिए। इतने में वहां पर महाप्रभु नित्यानंद प्रभु को कह के बोले नित्यानंद प्रभु समय निकलते हुए जा रहा है व्यास पूजा कर। नित्यानंद सर पे से हिला रहे भाव में बोले करो क्यों लेट कर रहे हो जल्दी जल्दी व्यास पूजा करो ना। इतने में वो जितने सारे सामग्री थी फूल की माला चंदन उन्होंने लेकर के श्री महाप्रभु की गला में सीधा पहना दिया। महाप्रभु की पूजा करते हुए उनके चरण के उन्होंने वंदन किया। अभी प्रश्न ही भैया व्यास मतलब विस्तार करना अभी मूल गुरुदेव कौन है बोले नित्यानंद प्रभु ये मूल है। इसलिए गुरुदेव की हम दो स्वरूप गुरुदेव को मानते हैं एक तो नित्यानंद प्रभु अभिन्न स्वरूप गुरुदेव दूसरे स्वरूप मानते हैं राधा रानी की जो प्रिय सखी हाँ त्रिपेक्षणिया तत्रादि दाक्षादति वल्लभस्य वंदे गुरुश्री चरणारविंद। गुरुदेव कौन है राधा रानी की जो निकुंज महल में राधा कृष्ण की जो सेवा में जो बहुत एक्सपर्ट है ये एक गुरुदेव है। और दूसरे स्वरूप मानते हैं श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु का अभिन्न प्रकाश श्री गुरुपाद पद्म। तब यहाँ पर व्यास पूजा में तो नित्यानंद प्रभु को पूजा होनी चाहिए लेकिन नित्यानंद प्रभु ने क्या किया सारे सब कुछ लेकर महाप्रभु गला कहने के लिए क्यों बोलन होता।
Now, who initiated this Vyasa Puja? Vyasa Puja was initiated by in the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime. We hear that how when Mahaprabhu used to reside in Navadvip, that time he used to every day in the night he is going and performing his sankirtan movement in Srivastava. Every day now he is during this time when the next day is Vyasa Puja. The next day is Vyasa Puja, and a day before Vyasa Puja. He used this instruction to Srivas and he said that tomorrow in your courtyard we will perform the Vyasa Puja because tomorrow is Vyasa Puja, so we perform this Vyasa Puja in your courtyard. When he gave this instruction, then he also asked to Srivas, he said that, oh, I have given you this instruction that you arrange for the Vyasa Puja. It looks like I have given a lot of burden on your shoulders. And that Srivas, with folded hands, he said, oh Lord, what are you saying that this is a burden? This is a great pleasure. We will have beautiful facilities, all the facilities by your mercy. We have all the facilities to arrange for the, to celebrate the festival tomorrow. What do we need? We just require some betel leaves, some betel nuts, and some flower garlands, etc. Whatever is needed, everything is available in my home. I will arrange everything. There is no need to worry, and very happily we will celebrate. Very beautiful Maha also we will celebrate today, tomorrow, the Vyasa Puja.
Hare Krishna. This way he gives teaching, now he gives very good teaching to Mahaprabhu through this Srivas Pandit. What is the teaching? Teaching is that when coming any Guru Varga appears and disappears today, necessary you must celebrate some Utsav. Every day what you making for your householder, what you making some prasad, when coming some Guru Varga, some appears and disappears today, you try making some little bit more, some preparation for Krishna, more preparation, nice some sabji, nice some pakora, nice love. What you making necessary that day, making nice thing for Guru Varga Seva. And that day you try also reading, sometimes Guru Varga appear disappear next day, you try to reading his past time, reading this past time. When you reading this past time of a Vaishnava, then coming so much enthusiasm to your heart, how Sanatana Goswami did bhajan, how Rupa Goswami did bhajan, how Sri Haridas Thakur chanting three lakh harinam, how our Guru Varga they are doing bhajan. So necessarily your house, when coming some day tithi, necessarily you can reading this past time and the instruction. This will give teaching. So there are the 32 kind of sevapara, 32 kind of sevapara. One sevapara is that, that ek sevapara rahe, tumhari samartha rahte hue bhi, tum Bhagavan ki seva nahi kar rahe. Jo matlab bitasatya. Bitasatya matlab paisa hai tumhari paas mein. Lekin ye paisa ko jo duniya ka ek kaam mein to khub laga dete ho. Lekin jab kisi guru varga ka tithi, thakur ka tithi mein, Bhagavan ke liye tum nahi lagate, usko bitasatya kehte hain. Kripanta. कंजूसी पॉइंट इसको अपराध होता है। भगवान जब तुमको दिए चट्ठा उची ठाकुर की सेवा है और भगवान की वैष्णव की सेवा जत्थ तो करनी चाहिए उसमें अपराध
He's discovering that this is an offense. That suppose you have the capability, you have the capacity, but still you use the money, you use the facilities, whatever you have, for everything in the world, whatever you need, you buy, you use it, but you don't use it for the seva of the Lord. That is called bitter shakya. Means you're being a miser. You're being a miser, and the Lord has given you all these facilities to serve the Lord, to serve the Guru Varga, and if you do not, it is considered as an offense.
Yeah, Ambala.
So then, by the instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has arranged all paraphernalia, and the next day when everybody gathers at his courtyard, they are performing the Vyasa Puja. And there is an auspicious time has been determined when the Vyasa Puja has to be performed. So now this time is approaching, and as the time is approaching, Mahaprabhu is telling to Nityananda Prabhu, the time is passing away, the auspicious time is passing away, come on, perform the Vyasa Puja quickly. And Nityananda Prabhu, he is just sitting and he's just nodding his head and he is not really paying attention. And then when he hurries him up, then what does he do? He gets up. All the paraphernalia that had been gathered there on Vyasa Puja, for Vyasa Dev, he took all the paraphernalia, the garland, etc. and he put it on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's neck, and everything, all the paraphernalia that had been gathered there, he utilized it to worship Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So like this, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu...
हम लोग गुरु वर्ग को दो स्वरूप में देखते हैं एक नित्यानंद प्रभु अर्जुन एक राधारण के प्रिय दासी स्वरूप में ये गुरु जी की ना दया की सारी हुई तो गुरुदेव नित्यानंद प्रभु आनंद रूपरी नियरेस्ट डियरेस्ट श्रीमती राधारायण वन सखी हुई तो वेरी एक्सपर्ट इज निकुंज सेवा सो गुरुदेव ऑफ टू फॉर्म कभी यहाँ प्रश्न आता है श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु ने ये माला महाप्रभु के गला में उन्होंने क्यों दिया है इसका क्या रहस्य है माला क्यों उनके गले में क्यों दिया हाँ यहाँ पर कहते हैं श्री प्रभुपाद इसी विषय पर प्रभुपाद कहते हैं हम गुरु जी को क्या समझते हैं एक राधा रानी की प्रिय दासी दूसरा है नित्यानंद प्रभु अवरण क्यों क्या सब गुरु ऐसे ही है इसलिए कहते हैं जगत में बहुत सारे गुरुदेव है हाँ सब अपना गुरुदेव को क्या कहते हैं ये सब भगवत अभिन्न स्वरूप भगवत अभिन्न स्वरूप क्या सबके सब प्रभुपाद नहीं अब सबको नहीं कह सकते वो ये नित्यानंद अभिन्न राधा रानी के प्रिय दासी बोले किसको कह सकते बोले जिसके अंदर ये गुण हो सिर्फ गुरु जैसे नित्यानंद प्रभु बलदेव प्रभु कृष्ण अभिन्न लेकिन होते हुए करते हैं क्या उनका एक्टिविटी क्या है कहते संपूर्ण रूप में पंच रस से और दस स्वरूप से वो कृष्ण सेवा करते हैं है? इसलिए सख्यात भगवत अभिन्न होते हुए भी संपूर्ण रूप में कृष्ण सेवा में अपना जीवन को लगा दिया मृदंग उनका स्वरूप कर्ता उनका स्वरूप सिंहासन उनका स्वरूप पादुका उनका स्वरूप आसन उनका स्वरूप व्यंजन छत्र सब नित्यानंद प्रभु कृष्ण का अलंकार इनके वस्त्र सब श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु जैसे वो अभिन्न होते हुए भी संपूर्ण रूप में कृष्ण सेवा कर रहे हैं उसी तरह अगर गुरुदेव संपूर्ण रूप में भगवत सेवा में ही अपना समय दे रहे उनकी सेवा के बगैर कुछ भी नहीं जानते वो व्यक्ति हो सकता है नित्यानंद अभिन्न राधा रानी के प्रिय दास स्वरूप सब गुरुदेव नहीं हो सकते
So, we were discussing that how Gurudev is manifests himself in two ways. One, he is non-different from Nithyananda and Prakash, and one, he is the very dear associate of Radha Rani. As he's serving Nikunja Kuna Yati Keli Siddhaya, means he is serving Radha Rani in deep in the Kunjas. So now Srila Bhaktivinoda Saraswati Prabhupada is asking this, then yeah, we should worship the Gurudev according to these two understandings. Now question arises, so every guru has to be worshipped like this? He said, no, this is not correct. That we, anybody who calls himself as Guru, he should be worshipped like this, considered him to be non-different from Nityananda Prabhu, and considered him to be somebody who is very near, dear associate of Radharani. Understand that, who is Nityananda Prabhu? Nityananda Prabhu is non-different from Krishna. And he has, in all five rasas, in all five, ten expansions, all ten expansions, he expanded himself, serving the Lord himself. In all five rasas and ten expansions. This chamar, this umbrella, this mridang, and this singhasan, and his jewelry, his cloth, everything he has expanded means, although he is non-different from Krishna himself, but still he is utilizing whatever way, however, every way that he can, he is serving the Lord. So understand that anybody who calls himself Guru, he must have this qualification in him. That if somebody is whatever situation, whatever he can, and in every situation he is serving the Lord, understand that that person can be understood to be somebody who is non-different from the time.
So, इसलिए उन्होंने बलदेव प्रभु नित्यानंद प्रभु ने क्या किया जितने सारे वहाँ पर सामग्री थी ना वो सबके सब महाप्रभु बुलाते थे सब महाप्रभु को जानते थे बिल्कुल क्यों बोले मूल व्यास कौन है बोले महाप्रभु कर कृष्ण बंदे जगतगुरु जगतगुरु कौन है बोले महाप्रभु जगतगुरु है इसलिए उन्होंने आदर्श दिया गुरु जी का काम ही हर वस्तु को भगवत सेवा में लगाना ही यही गुरु जी का आदर्श है इसलिए उन्होंने सब कुछ उन्होंने महाप्रभु की सेवा में महाप्रभु बला में महाप्रभु को उन्होंने पूजा की क्योंकि गुरुवर्ग यही सिखा देते हैं गुरु क्या करता है वो कहता है कि अपने भगवान मेरा सब पूजा मेरा नाम लो मेरा नहीं ये गुरु का काम नहीं गुरु का काम होता है क्या है कहते जीव को भगवत चरण में लगाना भगवत भजन में जैसे हमारे भारत में कुछ गुरु है कहते हैं जय गुरुदेव एक संप्रदाय है और बहुत सारे वो कहते भगवान भगवान कुछ नहीं गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरुदेव महेश्वर गुरु ही ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरुदेव सब कुछ भगवान भगवान कुछ नहीं इसलिए उनको मंदिर में ठाकुर को खबर कुछ नहीं बोले नहीं ये गुरु नहीं ये भ्रष्ट है सबके सब हाँ कहते भ्रष्ट है सबके सब ये गुरु नहीं गुरु वह है जो कि भगवत चरण की जो चरण को दर्शन कराते हैं ये गुरु जी इसलिए कहते अखंड मंडलाकारम व्याप्त जैन चराचरम तत्पद दर्शितम जैन तस्मै श्री गुरु जो भगवान की चरण की जो भक्ति को प्रदान करते हैं जैसे श्री नारद जी उन्होंने जो मंत्र दिया भगवान विष्णु की इसलिए गुरु का काम है भगवत चरण दर्शन करना
So, the question arises here that why did Nityananda Prabhu behave like this, that all the paraphernalia that had been gathered to worship Vyasadeva, to perform the Vyasa Puja, he used each and every paraphernalia to worship Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is because by his behavior, he's showing the ideal of a Gurudev, how a Gurudev should behave, how a Guru has to behave. What he has done, because he is the original Guru, he is the non-divided Guru, and what he is doing, everything that has been gathered for worship of Gurudev, who is actually the original Guru? Original Guru is Mahaprabhu himself. And because he is the original Guru, the task of the Guru is to worship one who is performing the task of Vyasadeva, one who is giving us all these spiritual understandings and all. So if suppose there are so many sampradayas in India, Jayavidya, etc., so many sampradayas who even don't even have the deities in their temple. They put themselves in the center and they take all the worship for themselves. They say that you worship me, I am different from Brahma.
There is Puran on a slope, Puran there on a slope. This slope is describing Guru Brahma, meaning Gurudev in the Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Gurudev in the Vishnu, Gurudev in Maheshwar, Gurudev in the Maheshwar, Guru Shiva. And Gurudev in the everything in the Gurudev, This slope they explain. But misunderstanding in this slope, So they are telling no need to any Krishna, no need to any Lord, and the Guru is everything. So you can say they are table no any Krishna's deity. Now the Ram, not Krishna, not Narayana, they are completely empty, and they are keep to Gurudev picture there. Okay? They are keep to Gurudev picture there. Prabhupada will know. They are Guru Bhogi. Kya bolte hain? Guru Bhogi.
They are enjoyers of Gurudev's facilities.
Isliye they are Guru Bhogi. So they are not actually Guru. Guru ka kaam kya hai?
What is the task of Gurudev? Gurudev's task is that he will take everything that is available to him and use it in the worship of the Lord. So this is the end. He will take whoever comes to him, he will take him and make him qualified to go in the service of the Lord. So this is the task of Gurudev. The Gurudev's task is not that whatever comes to him, he will utilize it himself. That I am the center, of the facility that you are providing. No. So that's why Nityananda Prabhu, by his behavior, he is showing the ideal, what a Gurudev has to be, how a Gurudev has to behave. That whatever has been gathered for worship of the Vyasadeva, he is utilizing in the service of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Blessed Gurudev ki
jai,
Blessed Das Puja ki
jai.
Kat aaj hamare Gurudev ji ka aaj avirbhav kriti hai. Hum log bade saubhagyavan hain, hum log jo ki hum idhar udhar kisi hain, kate sri kat hum kisi kya naam usko taal lene ke chakkar mein nahi pade. कलयुग में अक्सर करके सबके सब गुरुदेव काल नहीं है. ये गुरुदेव नहीं, सबके सब काल नहीं. बोले काल नहीं क्यों है? कहते ये काल में भी नहीं. जिस समय लक्ष्मण की शक्ति सैल हुई, जब सुषेण वैद्य ने बताया अगर एक रात का अंदर में अगर कोई दवा लेकर के आ सकते हैं, हैं, कहते गंधमार पर्वत से, कहते इसका जीवन बच सकती है. इतने में रावण ने क्या किया, काल नहीं को बोले किसी तरह से एक रात उसको रोक लो. और उसने साधु रूप धारण कर लिए और साधु रूप धारण करते हुए बीच में बैठ करके रघुपति राग को गाने लग दिया है. इतने में हनुमान भी जिसको कंफ्यूज हो गए, बोली कोई तो हमारा गुरु भैया है, हैं, ये रघुपति राग वो कह रहे हैं तो गुरु भैया, लेकिन इसलिए हनुमान जी उतर करके आ गए. लेकिन वो काल नहीं था, किसी तरह से उसको बुद्धि को भ्रमित करके उसको एक रात उसको रुकवा करके लक्ष्मण को मारना चाहता था. इसलिए यहाँ तक भी कहते ये रावण भी संन्यास रूप धारण किया था, काल ने भी राक्षस भी उसने साधु का रूप धारण किया था. इसलिए अच्छा है हम लोगों ने किसी काल ने भी चक्कर में नहीं पड़े, किसी रावण के चक्कर में नहीं पड़े. हम लोग भी शुद्ध वैष्णव परंपरा में आए, समझो हम लोग बड़े सौभाग्यवान.
सो हाउ फॉर्चुनेट आर वी? We are so fortunate, Ashoka Maharaj is describing, that we are very, very fortunate, maybe more fortunate than many, many billions of people on this planet. He's saying how? He's saying, we are very lucky that we have not got entangled in the web of some Kalneni or some Ravan. Because who was this Kalneni? Kalneni, he is dressing, he is adopting the garb or the dress of a sannyasi. One time when Lakshman has been shot, the Shakti said he has been shot by this Shakti arrow, and now Kaviraj is describing that within one night, this will have effect for one night, this poison will spread in one night, and after one night it is impossible to overcome this poison. So what you have to do, somebody has to go immediately to Gandhamalam, means that in the southernmost part of India, further down in Sri Lanka, from there one has to go to Himalayas, get this herb, whatever is needed, bring it back overnight. And if it doesn't happen overnight, then there is no way that I can save Lakshmi. So now Hanumanji is being sent because he can go through the air, Pavanputra. So he is the son of the wind god, so he can go through the air and he can get this, overnight he can get it. But Ravan, because he has spies all over, everybody has in their army, they have spies. So through these spies they understand that Hanuman is going to take this aerial route and he is going to get this herb. So he sends his Rakshas, one of his associates, Kalneni, and he tells him that you go and somehow just stop Hanuman for one night. And one night if he is stopped there on the way, then he will, Lakshman will die. So now Kalneni, on the path that he has to take, there he is sitting there and he is wearing the dress of a sannyasi. He is now chanting Raghupati, Raghav, Radha, like this. He is chanting the names of the Lord Ram and he is chanting these names. And Hanumanji, when he is going through the aerial route, Hanumanji's ears immediately stand in attention. If anybody chants the Lord Ram's names, the moment he hears these names of Lord Ram being chanted, he thinks, oh, this is my god brother who is chanting there. So he comes down from the aerial route and he sees that, oh, somebody is chanting in sannyasi. He says, oh, some very saintly person. And then Kalneni is also discussing with him that I can send you through a shorter route, you just want to take bath, I have cooked something for you, etc. So he's trying to absorb him in a situation.
And I also gave you Tikya Mantra. You go take shower, came here, I want to get to Tikya Mantra you. You know, after that, you know, when he killed this is the crocodile, then crocodile, you know, he's the heaven girl. then see that all, oh Hanuman, you are weak here. You know, this is not a call, name he the demon, and he is not a sadhu. Ravan he said to him, stop to be so don't stay there. Then Hanuman he killed this call name. You know, so he are telling if he call name is the demon, but he take the form of a sadhu. If he Hanuman he become bewildered, you know. Even Hanuman, he is a Shiva. Even he is become bewildered. You know, he also don't understand. So you are very, very fortunate, you know. You are coming to line of Mahaprabhu, you know, we are coming to line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they give teach to Rupa Goswami, Brahmanda Brahmite Kon Bhagyavani Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasadakaye Bhakti Lakavi. So here Prabhupada, he gave her a big committee. Yeah? He gave the big committee, he gave committee. Gurudev he gave to us mantra, but he had telling Guru Krishna Prasadakaye Bhakti Lakavi. He got the seat of Bhakti Lata, but mercy of Guru and a Krishna. Now coming, Prabhupada telling, why coming name of Krishna here? You are got mantra to see Gurudev. Why coming to name of Krishna here? So Prabhupada telling, you know, you are don't know who is the pure Guru, who is the impure Guru. You are don't know this thing. Who is the know this thing? Mostly in our India, there are very big, big Guru. Now everybody is jail now. You know, there is one with Asaram Bapu, you know. He, you know, what he doing? His classes coming, you know, hundred thousand people coming. What he doing? Oh, you want to take mantra? Who is the one take the Shiva mantra? You know, he telling the five mantra is chanting. Front mic, you know, openly. Shiva mantra, Devi mantra, you know, Krishna mantra, and Ganesha mantra. You know, there are five mantra in the chanting front of everybody. Well, who is the, you know, who is the like Shiva, they are taking Shiva mantra. Who is the like to Devi, you can't take this Devi mantra. Who like the Krishna, you can't take this Krishna mantra. This way, he can openly get this all mantra. And no any rule or any regulation, no. You can drink any tea, you can take, you know, any bad thing, no harm, you know. Like this now, he have so many, now he is in jail now. One is the Ram Rahim, you know, they are very famous person, you know. He have children, wife, so many. But our India, you know, very simple person. They are thinking, you know, Guru everybody. Now he also, now he is in jail now. You know, jail. After another one, now we are everybody jail now, you know. Everybody jail now they have. So Prabhupada he gave a commentary here. Only mercy of Krishna, where somebody without duplicate, they are takes shelter of Krishna, that Krishna he is the arrange to you where you can go and take to Diksha Mantra. Who is the arrange? Krishna he is the arrange. So when Dhruva Maharaj doing bhajan, Krishna Narayan himself said to Sri Narada to Sri Dhruva Maharaj, he can go and give to Diksha Mantra to him. So you are very, very fortunate. You know, you are came to see Mahaprabhu line and the Sutta Vaishnava line, you are came, accept to some pure devotee lotus feet. You know, our Gurudev, Kadhamaraji Gurudev, he was Sadharana Vyakti, he Radharani Swayam, our Gurudev was Sthapan Vyakti. जो कुछ साल पहले जब हमारी ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा चल रहा था उसमें सेवा कुंज का जो पुजारी था उसने प्रसाद और ठाकुर की माला लेकर गया है बोले हम महाराज से मिलना चाहते माता महाराज तो सबको मिलने नहीं देते बोले क्यों मिलना चाहते हो बताओ बोले मैं प्रसाद लेकर गया है माला बोले मेरे को दे दो मैं दे दूंगा बोले नहीं मैं गुरुदेव से डायरेक्ट कुछ बात करना चाहता हूँ तो गुरुदेव के पास मिले गए तो बोले मेरे को रात में राधारानी स्वप्न दिए और ये प्रसाद दिए और फूल की माला बोले जो नारायण महाराज ये मेरे सखी है और तुम जा करके ये प्रसाद माला और प्रसाद लेकर के नारायण महाराज को देख लेता जब गुरुदेव की बात बोले गुरुदेव का आंखों से आंसू की जय बहने लगी राधा रानी मेरे पास में प्रसाद और फूलों की माला ले गए तब गुरुदेव सब कुछ ना कुछ देते हैं प्रणाम तो उन्होंने 1001 रुपया निकाल कर प्रणाम दे रहे थे बोले मैं सबसे प्रणाम लेता हूँ लेकिन आपसे मैं प्रणाम नहीं ले सकता क्यों राधा रानी मेरे को सुखना आदेश होते आपके पास में भेजे मैं ये नहीं ले सकता हूँ इसका मतलब स्वयं राधा रानी वो स्थापन करती हैं, हमारा जो महाराज है वो रमण मंजरी है, इनका सीता स्वरूप महाराज स्वयं लिख कर गए ये रमण मंजरी है। इसलिए हम लोग बड़े सौभाग्य बा जो गुरुदेव की शरण में, ऐसे गुरु जी की शरण में हम लोग आए।
Our Gurudev, definitely he was no ordinary person, we know this, but also there is a practical establishment by Radha Rani herself. She established this herself. One day it was Kartik time and we were staying in Gopinandavan, and then a pujari from Sevakunj, he came and he had some prasad and some garland from Sevakunj temple, and he brought this prasad, and then he came that I want to see Gurudev, but you know, Madhav Maharaj as a security guard, he usually doesn't let many people meet Gurudev. So he stopped him. They said, why do you want to meet Gurudev? He said, oh, I have brought some prasad and some garland from the temple in Sevakun. I want to give this to Gurudev. And then he said that you can give this to me and I can pass this on to him. And this pujari said that no, I want to give this myself, and also I want to say something to him. Then somehow Madhav Maharaj, he brought him to Gurudev. And then he gave this. He said, I got a dream in the night, and I got a dream in the night, and I was told, I was instructed that I should take this garland, I should take this prasad to give to you by Radharani herself. She, Radharani herself, came in my dream and she said that give this to you. And then Gurudev, when he heard this, that Radharani came in the dream, he started shedding tears, that he had tears in his eyes. Yes, he is my very dear Sakhi. Then you go and please this, give this to him. And Gurudev heard this, he started shedding tears. And then Gurudev was saying that Gurudev thought that, oh, Radharani herself has sent this to me. Yes, of course, he accepted this very honorably. And then whenever somebody brings something to him like this from Braj, etc., he would give some pranami. So he took out 1,101 rupees and he wanted to give to this pujari. He gave this to this pujari. Pujari said that, I take pranamis for everybody whoever comes in Vrindavan, but I cannot accept it from you. He said, why? You should take it. He said, no, I have been instructed by Radharani herself that I should give this to you. I cannot accept this from you. So understand that we are most fortunate people. Somehow, by the arrangement of Krishna, we have come to Gurudev.
So, Gurudev himself, you know, he told, he is the Raman Manjari, you know. He is the eternal identification, he is the Ramana Manjari, he is the Gurudev. So, you are very, very fortunate. You are, everybody came to see Gurudev and this life. So, you are very, very fortunate. आज गुरुदेव की जन्मतिथि है, इसलिए माता कुंती कहती है कृष्ण को, बोले प्रभु जिसको पास में एक चीज हो जाएगी ना, तेरा भजन नहीं करेगा, एक गुण अगर आ जाए, लेकिन जिसको पास में चार चीज हो तो कभी तेरा भजन नहीं कर सकता है, बड़े कठिन है। बोले वो क्या क्या है? बोले जन्म ऐश्वर्य स्तुत श्री हरे दमान मदकुमान, कहते चार व्यक्ति के अंदर बड़ी घमंड आ जाती है, भजन नहीं करते। बोले पहला नंबर जन्म, किसी अच्छे कुल में जन्म हो जाए, ऐश्वर्य ज्यादा पैसा, श्री मतलब सुंदरता ज्ञान है, कहते अगर किसके अंदर में एक गुण भी आ जाए ना, वो कभी तेरा भजन नहीं करेगा। लेकिन हम देखते हैं हमारे गुरु जी के अंदर में ये जो चार चार वस्तु पूर्ण रूप में गुरु जी पास में था। बोले जैसे जन्म, कहते गुरुदेव जन्म कहाँ पर लिए है? बोले छोटे मोटे कुल में नहीं, ब्राह्मण कुल में, और छोटे ब्राह्मण अंदर भी क्या क्या हुई है, कहते हमारे गुरुदेव जो जन्म लिए हैं, कहते गुरुदेव तिवारी वंश, तिवारी मतलब ब्राह्मण में भी वो श्रेष्ठ ब्राह्मण कुल में जन्म हुई। जन्म हुए कहाँ पर? बोले साधारण जगह में नहीं, बक्सर। बोले ये बक्सर कहाँ पर है? कहते जहाँ पर श्री विश्वामित्र जी की यज्ञ सभा था, विश्वामित्र जी की भजन स्थली, केवल भजन स्थली नहीं विश्वामित्र जी की, कहते जहाँ पर स्वयं भगवान राम लक्ष्मण सीता जहाँ पर निवास किया, जहाँ पर भगवान राम ने, जहाँ पर उन्होंने श्री तारका का वध किए। इसलिए जो अत्यंत अत्यंत जो पवित्र स्थान है, कहते हमारे गुरु जी का जो जन्म ये पवित्र स्थान में भी है।
So, Kunti Devi is saying in Srimad Bhagavatam, she is saying that if somebody has one of these four qualities, then it is very difficult for him to perform bhajan. She is saying, Janma Aishwarya
Shruta
Shruti Shribhi. She's saying, if suppose somebody has Jan, high class birth, Aishwarya opulence, Shruti means he is knowledgeable, and Shri means he is very handsome looking, very good looking. Suppose somebody is beautiful, they have any of these one qualities somebody will have, then we will find that that person will find it very difficult to perform well. But although, see, she's saying that among these four qualities, if somebody has one, then it will be difficult to perform well. But Gurudev, in his life, we see that actually he had all these four qualities in full manner. How? His Janma. Where did he take birth? First of all, he took birth in a not an ordinary family. He took birth in India in a very nice Brahmin family. There are amongst the Brahmin family also, in Tiwari family, among Brahmin family also, there are gradations. And he took this Tiwari is a very high class Brahmin family. So he first he took birth in a very high class Brahmin family. And then where did he take birth? He took birth in Buxar, in Bihar. Buxar is that place where was the Yagishala and the place of austerities of Vishwamitra Muni. And not only that, the Vishwamitra Muni performed, he had his Yagishala and he performed austerities there. Even Ram, Lakshman, and Sita, during the time of their exile, they stayed in this place. So understand that by his this taking birth, that he has taken a very high class birth.
And near that place is the Ikil Taraka.
Yes, Taraka demon is also at this place.
मतलब जो पैसा है कहते ऐश्वर्य कहते श्रुत का मतलब होता है ज्ञान
and ashwarya means the opulence. So for somebody has opulence, then he finds it very difficult to perform with it. And Gurudev, he was a police officer in India, whether you want it or not. But in India, if somebody has a position in police, then he will be offered whatever salary. He maybe not be very bothered about salary. You'll get so much more, and he gets so much more in bribes. You want it or you don't want it. It is like this in India, because everybody is performing so many illegal activities, and that's why to hide themselves, to find a shelter from the police, they give so much bribe to the police. And then Gurudev had this, means he had such an opportunity, but still he was such a, and then Shruta?
Janma Aishwarya Vila Shruta. Shruta ka matlab hota hai gyan. Gurudev gyan. Gurudev aise atha gyan Gurudev ko. जिन लोगों ने गुरुदेव की संगत की उनको स्वभाव पता है जो गुरुदेव की, इसलिए मैं जब पुरी में रहता था, गुरुदेव रहते थे मथुरा में, मेरे मन में बचपन से बड़ी इच्छा थी। अभी दो व्यक्ति इसी जगह पर मिले जो बच्चों को बड़ी अच्छी हरि कथा सिखाते, बोले कौन है? बोले मथुरा में एक श्री नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज है और दूसरे भुवनेश्वर में श्री गौर गोविंद महाराज है। कहते जो दो व्यक्ति है इसी समय में बड़े सुंदर हरि कथा बोलते हैं और बच्चों को हरिकथा भी सिखा देते हैं। इसलिए सचमुच से जब मैं मथुरा में आया, वहां पर देखा हर गौड़ीय मठ में केवल एक बार हरिकथा होती है, लेकिन जब मथुरा में आकर देखा, जब गुरु वर्गों की कोई तिथि होना, गुरुदेव चार चार बार हरिकथा बोलते थे कथा की। इसलिए गुरुदेव को कहते थे टच स्टोन थे, जिसे टच स्टोन में लोहे को स्पर्श कराने पर जैसे लोहे को सोने बना देती है, गुरुदेव के अंदर में ऐसे केवल गुरुदेव आप कुछ भी पढ़ने का जरूरत नहीं, केवल गुरुदेव की जो कथा को केवल आप ध्यान से सुनो, आप एकदम सोने बन जाओगे है? एकदम सोने बन जाओगे ऐसे गुरुदेव के अंदर में, ऐसे दिव्य ध्यान गुरुदेव के अंदर में वहां चार चार बार वहां पर बैठा हुआ करते थे।
तो श्रीधर महाराज डिस्क्राइबिंग दैट नाउ व्हेन ही वाज वेरी यंग देन ही हैड दिस डिजायर दैट आई वांट टू हियर एंड आई वांट टू लर्न हरिकथा। So he found out, and he was born near Puri. So he found out that he wants to learn, and he spoke to many people, and came to hear two names. He said in those days he came to hear two names, that there are two very prominent people who are having this reputation, that they speak very nice, beautiful harikatha, and they are teaching to young kids like me, and they are giving these beautiful harikatha to young people. He said, but by misfortune, that by the time I decided to come, so by the time he decided that he will go to Srila Gauravind Maharaj, because Gauravind Maharaj was in Bhubaneswar, and he had heard Pujavasala, our Gurudev's name, Pujavasala Narayan Goswami Maharaj, in Mathura, he's speaking Harikatha. He's saying, by the time I decided that I will go and learn Harikatha now, I'm ready to go leave my home to learn Harikatha, By that time already Pujavashila Gauravin Maharaj had left the planet. He said now he had only one choice to go to Mathura. He said, and really when I went, I heard his reputation that he speaks Harikatha. And when I came to hear Harikatha from him in Mathura, he said, other mutts maybe they are one time or maybe two times maximum, maybe even not even one time actually, every day Harikatha. So, but at the times of the festivals like Guru Vart, Samtithi, etc., he's describing that he, Gurudev, used to speak Harikatha four times. Four times he used to speak. One in the morning, then in the afternoon, then in the evening, and then after Arati again speaking Harikatha. So Gurudev, he's saying that Gurudev is like touchstone. He's any touchstone, you touch iron to the touchstone, it turns to gold. Similarly, listen Gurudev's Harikatha and you will turn to gold. This is the shrut, means he had so much knowledge and so much Harikatha in him.
इसलिए गुरुदेव जब मथुरा में थे जितने दूसरे दूसरे जो शिष्य थे हाँ जो सबके सब गुरुदेव के पास में आकर कथा सुनते थे जैसे इलाहाबाद में श्री गौर गोविंद महाराज के जो भक्त लोग थे हाँ वो लोग भी आए इनका जो शिष्य है अभी गुरुदेव ने उनको सबको संन्यास दिया है जिसमें भक्तिवेदांत आश्रम महाराज फिर अरण्य महाराज थे श्रौती महाराज हैं हमारे सुधादित्य महाराज फिर मुन्नी महाराज ये सब के सब उसके गौर गोविंद महाराज के सब उनको पास में थे जब उन्हें चले गए तो इधर उधर उन्होंने गुरुदेव के पास में आए और वो सब अच्छे अच्छे निकले गौर गोविंद महाराज के पास में जो जो भक्त लोग थे सब अच्छे अच्छे निकले क्योंकि उनका शिक्षा बहुत अच्छी शिक्षा थी इसलिए गुरुदेव के पास में आए गुरुदेव सबके सब गुरुदेव ने संन्यास सबको दिया और सर्वत्र उनको प्रचार करने के लिए गुरुदेव ने उनको सबके पास में भेजे इसलिए गुरुदेव के अंदर में जो ज्ञान है हम देखते थे एक सब्जेक्ट के ऊपर में कितने तरह तरह का गुरुदेव व्याख्या करते थे हर समय नए नए इसलिए दूसरे दूसरे के शिष्य लोग सबके सब गुरुदेव के पास में आकर के सब सब कथा सुनते थे गुरुदेव के पास में
He's describing that how Gurudev used to speak on every subject matter. He would speak from different angles and so much Harikatha he had that all the disciples of other gurus also used to come to him. We know that how when Pujavashila Gaur Govind Maharaj left and many of his prominent disciples also, many of the disciples came and many of the disciples from Pujavashila Gaur Govind Maharaj, they also took sannyas from him. Our Gurudev gave sannyas with him like Shruti Maharaj, Shudhavati Maharaj, Aranya Maharaj and Ashram Maharaj.
So
Muni Maharaj. So all these, they took sannyas from Gurudev. And Gurudev is saying that he was always had so much baggage of Harikatha that he would speak on every topic, he would speak for hours and hours and hours from different angles, he would describe so many Harikatha.
Janma Aishabja Shruta Kata Sri, Sri Matalavata hai, Sundarata. कि जब मैंने सर्वप्रथम जब मंदिर में आए मथुरा मठ में आए हैं जब मैंने देखा गुरुदेव को देखा गुरुदेव का चेहरा देखो वो लगते हैं जैसे भारतीय नहीं अंग्रेजी है ऐसे गुरुदेव का चेहरा में जो रंग है इसलिए और उनका जो आँख है ना नीली नीली आँख है नीली आँख किस यहाँ पर किसकी है नीली नीली आँख में जो पुतली है ना किसके नीली नहीं होती है लेकिन गुरुदेव की देखा आँख देखे ना एकदम नीली आँख जैसे एकदम पूरा नीली आँख इसलिए मैं जब मथुरा में सर्वप्रथम आया तो गुरुदेव को देख करके मैंने सोचा ये क्या कोई विदेशी ना कोई देसी है इसलिए मैं सोचती थी विदेशी ना देसी एकदम जैसे उनका मुंह एकदम लाल रंग के जैसे हाँ एकदम राधा रंग का जैसे रंग है ना ऐसे गुरुदेव का रंग शरीर का रंग वैसे देखने में बड़े सुंदर थे इसलिए महाराज का जो चेहरा है बड़े सुंदर चेहरा था
And the next quality that Gurudev described, Shri, means the beauty. And he said that when I came to Gurudev for the first time, and it was winter time. It was winter and Gurudev, I saw Gurudev and he was wearing some scarf, etc. And it was, he was looking like the complexion of the Western people, fair in complexion and blue eye. He said, look amongst yourself, we are in Western country today, look amongst yourself how many blue eye people we have there. And Gurudev, he had blue eye. When I came and saw him, that how effulgent and how beautiful his complexion and blue eye, he said, I begin to doubt that is he Indian or he is Western? He was so handsome.
इसलिए कहते इनके अंदर में ये चार चार गुण पूर्ण रूप में लेकिन पूर्ण रूप में होते हुए भी वो भगवत भजन करते थे इसका मतलब है गुरुदेव कोई साधारण व्यक्ति थे नहीं इस दुनिया की कोई साधारण व्यक्ति थे नहीं वो राधा रानी की नित्य परिकर है
So understand that although he had all these four qualities in him to the fullest, all these appearances to the fullest, but still having all these appearances, he's still performing bhajan to Radha Mani and Krishna. Understand that is definitely no ordinary person.
इसलिए हम इनको उदाहरण गुरुदेव का हम उदाहरण देते हैं. गुरुदेव जैसे श्री जीव गोस्वामी का उदाहरण हम उनको देते हैं. कैसे श्री जीव गोस्वामी कहते हैं कि जो नरोत्तम श्यामानंद और श्रीनिवास कहते हैं तीनों व्यक्ति थे जिन्होंने जीव गोस्वामी के पास में उन्होंने आकर के सारे शास्त्र को अध्ययन किए. लेकिन जो जीव गोस्वामी का ही कोई शिष्य नहीं थे. ये दूसरे दूसरे के सब कोई गोपाल भट्ट गोस्वामी के कोई लोकनाथ दास गोस्वामी के कोई श्रीनिवास आचार्य के तीनों थे. लेकिन श्री जीव गोस्वामी ये सबको उन्होंने शास्त्र की शिक्षा दी और बाद में ये तीनों को उन्होंने तीन दिशाओं में भेजे और सारा दुनिया में ये तीनों व्यक्ति हरि भक्ति को प्रचार किया. इसलिए हम गुरु जी के अंदर में भी यही चीज देखते हैं. इसलिए अक्सर करके गुरुदेव के पास में जो अभी दुनिया में प्रचार कर रहे हैं अक्सर करके उनका शिष्य कब और उनका जो शिष्य नहीं जाता है शास्त्र ज्यादा है. कर देखो जैसे श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज का जितने शिष्य है श्री पद्मना महाराज नेमी महाराज श्रावती महाराज उनके शिष्य और इस सब कैसे उनके शिष्य है श्री सज्जन महाराज हैं. इन्होंने इनको पास में आकर के सारे शास्त्र को और मैं जैसे अलग जगह से जैसे सिद्धार्थ महाराज आए अलग जगह से ये सब के सब गौर गोविंद महाराज के शिष्य लोग आए अलग जगह से. और गुरुदेव ने इनके अंदर में अक्सर कर जो ज्यादा जो लड़ाई होता है ना ये मेरे शिष्य तेरे शिष्य तेरे शिष्य तेरे ज्यादा ज्यादा लड़ाई होता है. लेकिन मैं गुरुदेव के अंदर में एक विशेष चीज हमने देखा गुरुदेव के अंदर मैं मेरा तय करा नहीं था. वो सबको अपना थे तभी तो सारा दुनिया गुरु जी की शरण में आए सारा पृथ्वी गुरु जी की शरण में आया था. क्यों इनके अंदर में ये भावना थी नहीं इसका शिष्य इसका शिष्य इसका शिष्य. मैं देखता था गुरुदेव जिसकी अंदर में जितने भक्ति की भावना गुरुदेव उसको उतना ही प्रेम करते थे. वो नहीं देखते थे ये मेरे शिष्य तेरे शिष्य जितनी भी भक्ति की भावना थी और सबको उन्होंने भक्ति शिक्षा दी. और देखो संपूर्ण विश्व में अगर कोई धर्म प्रचार कर रहे हैं यही लोग कर रहे हैं. सिद्धांत महाराज को दूसरे तरफ में बर महाराज को देखो माधव महाराज देखो तीर्थ महाराज उनको बाबू गोस्वामी महाराज का अस्तित्व दूसरे तरफ में मैं भी दूसरे तरफ में स्वामी महाराज के तीसरे तरफ में सारा पृथ्वी में अभी उनकी सब शिक्षा शिष्य जैसे जीव गोस्वामी ने भेजा सारा दुनिया में उनकी शिक्षा शिष्य ने सारा दुनिया में हरि भक्ति प्रचार कर रहे हैं.
He's saying that I see some similarity than our Gurudev and Srila Jiva Goswami Prabhupada. He's describing that how, just like Jiva Goswami Prabhupada had three prominent disciples, Shyamananda,
Narottama,
Srinivasa, they had these three disciples. And all these three disciples, actually, although he taught them and he sent them in different directions to preach, but actually they were not his Viksha disciples. He just gave them shiksha, but then he made them so prominent that they became so powerful and they preached in so many places we know about them. And similarly in our Gurudev's life also we see that all the devotees, all the gurus who are preaching today, they are actually none of his shiksha disciples, they are none of his diksha disciples. They are only his shiksha disciples. You see, Shruti Maharaj, he's saying, I myself, Vaman Maharaj, Pujavashila, Madhav Maharaj, and Padmana Maharaj, the disciples of Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, they all, the Padmana Maharaj, Nehmi Maharaj, all of them, they are preaching in different directions, but actually none of them are actually his initiated disciples. Usually you will see whatever conflict there is in some temple, it is usually that, oh, this is my disciple and this is your disciple and he should serve me and don't disturb my disciple. My disciple should be put in a prominent place. But Gurudev never had such thoughts in his heart. He always, whomever he found that he had some inclination towards bhakti, he would encourage that person. Siddhanti Maharaj, look at that, how this different from different gurus and different disciples came and took his shelter and now they are preaching prominently in so many ways. This was Gurudev's speciality. He says that I find that Gurudev had this speciality that whoever he found that he had
This
is a symptom of Mahabhagavata.
Kati Sri Guru Pad Padma mein hum unko udaharan dete hain. Kati ye teen mridang hota hai. Teen mridang hai. कहते एक ये मृदंग दूसरा मृदंग बृहद मृदंग और एक होता है जीवंत मृदंग. कहते ये तीन मृदंग है. कहते गुरु जी के अंदर में ये तीन मृदंग पूर्ण रूप में दिखता है. जैसे पहला मृदंग है ये मृदंग. गुरुदेव जब मैं मथुरा में आया गुरुदेव का हमने देखा क्या सुंदर भजन गाते जो अभी शायद सवेरे यहाँ पर भजन गा रहे थे नमामि स्वरम सचिदानंद रूपम. हर गौड़ी मठ में जब देखोगे ये इसको कोई गाते नहीं. कार्तिक महीना में देखा नमानी थे। लेकिन जब मथुरा में नहीं आया देखा गुरुदेव को, क्या गुरुदेव का जो कंठ है जैसे कोयल जैसे कुहकती है ना, इसलिए गुरुदेव का कंठ ठीक कोयल जैसे कुहकती है। इतने सुंदर गुरुदेव भजन गाते थे, मैं तो सुन सुन धन रह गया। हाँ इतने सुंदर जैसे उसे गाते ना एक श्लोक जैसे बोले नमानीश्वरम सचिदानंद रूप another Gaudiya Bhatt, you know, they are never singing this tune. You know, every Kartik month, you know, only they are read, but anybody not see. But when I have come to Mathura, then I saw how Gurudev sing this kirtan like kaku, you know. Gurudev don't like the kaku word like this, kaku bhais, very beautiful bhais Gurudev. So, this one kirtan, many times I saw, they are made play, this is Gurudev, this kirtan. महाराज जी यहाँ पर गवा रहे थे। बोले नमामीश्वर सच्चिदानंद रूप
first time this was the melody that he sang, that which I was singing, this was the melody that Gurudev used to sing. Other places, they in Kartik, they also sing this Namamishwaram, and they also know this Namamishwaram, but they usually nobody sings in the mud. They usually just narrate it or just read it. But here I used to come and I used to see that Gurudev used to sing this in such a beautiful manner. And Gurudev used to say that, he's describing that our Pujya Vashva Param Gurudev Bhakti Priyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj, when somebody came to him and he had desire to learn the singing, some bhajans, etc. So then he would come to Pujya Vashva Bhakti Priyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj. Then Bhakti Priyan, our Param Gurudev would say that you go to Gaur Narayan. Gaur Narayan means the name, the Brahmachari name of our Gurudev. Then you go and learn from Gaur Narayan, because he had firm faith, he knew that our Gurudev was such a good singer. He was saying that I saw him so many times, that he was such a good singer. And not only that he was a good singer, he was saying that whenever Param Gurudev, he would understand just by the whatever he had cooked, the moment he would eat, he would understand that today this has been made by Gaur Narayan. He said, whenever I used to make Gurudev, he said that he used to tell me that whenever I used to make our Param Gurudev, we used to love this cooking also. So this is the first rhythm, that he was a very good singer and also he used to play the rhythm very beautifully.
कहते दूसरा जो मृदंग है कहते ये बृहत मृदंग कहते ये ग्रंथक हो कहते इनके भी अवदान बहुत बड़ा है कहते विशेष करके हमारे गौड़ीय संप्रदाय में कहते दो तीन व्यक्ति जो ग्रंथों के ऊपर में बहुत काम किए हैं कहते पहला नंबर में तो भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज ने बड़े सुंदर बहुत सारे ग्रंथों को उन्होंने ट्रांसलेशन किया है और श्री भक्ति रक्षा श्रीधर गोस्वामी महाराज इन्होंने भक्ति रसामृत को और बड़े सुंदर सुंदर ग्रंथों को भक्ति रक्षा श्रीधर गोस्वामी महाराज बहुत सारे ग्रंथों को उन्होंने प्रकाशित किया है और तीसरी व्यक्ति आता है हमारे भक्ति वेदांत सिंह नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज फिर इन्होंने इतने ग्रंथों को उसने ट्रांसलेशन किया सर्वप्रथम उन्होंने जयवधर्म को ट्रांसलेशन किया पहले इनको जो हिंदी भाषी में इनकी इतने अवदान गुरुदेव की इतने अवदान गुरुदेव की बहुत बड़ा अवदान है अक्षर ग्रंथ कितने हृदयगत गौड़ीय वैष्णव सर्वप्रथम केवल गुरु महाराज महाराज जी हुए जो हिंदी ग्रंथ में ग्रंथों को इतने ट्रांसलेशन किया हाँ इतने ग्रंथ शिक्षाष्टकम उपदेशामृतम मन शिक्षा सत्क्रिया सार दीपिका है और श्री भागवत मरीचिमाला और वेणुगीत जुगल गीत भ्रमर गीत रासलीला भागवतम मतलब इतने गुरुदेव इतने ग्रंथों को उन्होंने प्रकाशित किया हिंदी भाषी अगर ये नहीं आ रहे ना ये हिंदी भाषियों को ये महाप्रभु का जो तत्व दर्शन है महाप्रभु का शिक्षा तो मिलती है उसके बाद में फिर अंग्रेजी में भक्त लोगों ने बहु भाषा में ट्रांसलेशन किया इसलिए दूसरे मृदंग जो बृहत मृदंग ग्रंथ है उनकी बहुत बहुत बड़ा प्रदान है
So, secondly, where the scriptures, the books, we know that in the recent times there are three acharyas who are prominent, who are well known for their publishing of the books. One is, of course, Pujya Vashva Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. He translated and he wrote so many books. And then his son, second is Pujya Vashva Sridhar Maharaj. He wrote
Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj.
Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Maharaj, that he translated Bhakti Rasam Sindhu and so many other books also he wrote and he translated. And then the third person that is very prominent in the books is our Gurudev Pujya Vashva Bhaktivedanta Swami Narayana Goswami Maharaj. So especially his contribution towards the translations of the Goswami's books in Hindi. It is actually he was the pioneer of the one who translated all the books of Goswami's into Hindi. His contribution in Hindi is unprecedented and he after later on of course so many devotees that he quoted so many names on the books that he translated. He quoted so many names and then later on of course the devotees translated in English and other languages also. So his contribution towards the scriptures is wonderful and very astonishing.
This is a Brihat Mridan. You know Brihat Mridan? Also my Gurudev also publication so many scriptures. My Bhakti Sarup and Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, all Vedanta Sutra, Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita, so many Uddhava Sandesh, Bindu, Kiran, Kana, and this is the so many Gauri Viti Gucha, so many my Gurudev also publication, so many scripture. My Gurudev also publication this scripture. So kati ye aur jo tisra mridang hai jivant mridang kati jivant mridang kehte hain jo swayam jisne mridang roop mein prachar karna isliye mahaprabhu ka jo bhavishyavani tha prithvi te aachijat nagara digra sarvatra prachar hai mahana ek din aisa aayega sampurna prithvi mein महाप्रभु का वाणी संपूर्ण पृथ्वी में गली गलियों में शहर शहर में सबके सब लोग प्रसन्न होकर के बोल हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम राम बोल हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
महाप्रभु का भजन सुन बैठा सबके सब प्रसन्न होकर हरि नाम करेंगे। श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज सब गुरुद्वार, उसके बाद में गौरव गुरुद्वार महाराज आए हैं, उसके बाद में हमारे महाराज जी, उसके बाद में हमारे महाराज कहते संपूर्ण पृथ्वी को साल में दो बार संपूर्ण पृथ्वी को परिक्रमा करते ऐसे कहते 15 ना कितने साल तक गुरुदेव ने संपूर्ण पृथ्वी को उन्होंने पूरा परिक्रमा की। सर्वत्र जा जाकर महाप्रभु का वाणी को शुद्ध नाम को उन्होंने प्रचार किया है। गुरुदेव ने ये जीवन का मृदंग है।
And the Jivan Mridang, third Mridang, the Jivan Mridang means the person who himself is acting as Mridang, means who himself is preaching all over. We know that Gurudev for 15 years he traveled so widely all over the planet. He used to travel and he used to preach. He himself as the ideal person for preaching. He's preaching all over. We know that he has gone to so many countries because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has predicted that will come a time when they will chant like this, Hare Krishna, like this, they will chant all of them together. And Gurudev's contribution, we know that in the beginning to the Western countries came Puja Vashala Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and then came Puja Vashala Srila Gaur Govind Maharaj, and then our Gurudev, he has contributed so much to fulfill the prediction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that all over the world, in every town, in every village, will be chanted his names.
कहते ये जीवन का मृदंग, इसलिए हम कहते हैं श्री गुरुदेव इनका जो नाम किया है बोले नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज भक्ति वेदांत से लव नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज। अभी प्रश्न है बोले इनका नाम नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज क्यों पड़ा। कहते हमारे भारत में जब कोई जन्म होता है ना ऐसे नहीं जो मुंह में आ गया वो नाम देते, ऐसे नहीं, वो पंचांग देख करके, जन्म देख करके, नक्षत्र देख करके उसका नामकरण होता है। इसलिए उनका घर का नाम था नारायण है तिवारी। लेकिन जब गुरु जी को पास में आए फिर उन्हें रखा गौर नारायण। फिर जब सन्यास लिए फिर क्या नाम हो गया, फिर नाम हो गया श्री भक्ति वेदांत नारायण गोस्वामी। इनका नाम ही नारायण 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 थी सब जगह नारायण बोले क्यों। इसलिए एक वैष्णव बड़े सुंदर व्याख्या कर रहे थे बोले नारायण का मतलब क्या है। बोले नारायण का पहला मतलब होता है नर, मतलब भगवान का नाम नारायण, नर मतलब जगत में जितने इंसान हैं, आयन मतलब आश्रय, मतलब हर जीवों का जो आश्रय दाता, इसलिए भगवान का नाम नारायण। हर जीवों को जो चरण में आश्रय दिया, हम देखते गुरुदेव भी हर जीव को उन्होंने चरण में आश्रय दिया है। हमने देखा है कोई भी गुरुजन को शरण में कोई भी आ गए एक बार गुरुदेव सबको मैं मेरा नहीं करके है, कोई भी आ गए उनको गुरु जी चरण में स्थान देते थे, सबको स्थान देकर गुरुदेव ने सबको शिक्षा प्रदान करते थे। इसलिए एक अर्थ है श्री नारायण। दूसरा नारायण नर मतलब होता है रस, कहते आयन मतलब होता है आश्रय, कहते सारे रस का जो आश्रय है। इसलिए गुरुदेव का अक्सर अगर आप कथा सुना गुरुदेव का अक्सर करके जो कथा रस कथा है, ज्यादा से ज्यादा अभी कथा उन्होंने रस कथा। इसलिए पद्मनाभ महाराज एक दिन बहुत अच्छी बात बता रहे थे, भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज आए विदेश में, उन्होंने संबंध ज्ञान को उन्होंने सबको दिया, कृष्णा कौन है सुप्रीम पार्टनर गंगा रेड कृष्णा है, उन्होंने संबंध ज्ञान को प्रदान किया। कहते भक्ति रखे श्रीधर गोस्वामी महाराज, उन्होंने अक्सर करीब का जो जितने ग्रंथ है आप देखिएगा उन्होंने अविधेय तत्व को उन्होंने स्थापन किया है, भक्ति ही अविधेय प्रोसेस। लेकिन हमारे महाराज जिस चीज को दिया कहते उन्होंने प्रयोजन तत्व को उन्होंने स्थापन किया। अक्सर करके इनके ग्रंथ में पढ़ो, अक्सर करके ज्यादा ग्रंथ हो प्रयोजन को उन्होंने बताए। फिर जीव का जो लक्ष्य है क्या है, महाप्रभु ब्रह्मा का एक दिन आकर के वही ब्रज प्रेम को देने के लिए आते थे। इसलिए हमारा जो लक्ष्य गुरुदेव कहते थे पहले अपना लक्ष्य को स्थिर करो, उसको बाद में फिर उसको पाने के लिए कोशिश करो। इसलिए पहले क्या करो अपना लक्ष्य को स्थिर करो। इसलिए गुरुदेव कहते पहले भले जन्म जन्मांतर लग जाए कोई बात नहीं, लेकिन पहले हमें अपना लक्ष्य को स्थिर करना चाहिए।
So he is describing that why and how his name was Narayan. There are different some versions for describing different definitions of Narayan. He is describing that how when he was born, then his name was given by according to the qualities that he had, according to seeing his astrological chart, what he will do in the future, then he was given this name Narayan. As a child, his name was Narayan. In India, they don't keep the names like what is musically sounding, a very, very nice musically sounding, Tinko Minko, something like that. No. They, whatever the name is given, that is according to what the quality they see in the child. So Gurudev's name was kept as Narayan. And later on, when he came as a Brahmachari, he was in the Mayapur Math, in the Navadi Math. That time his name was given as God Narayan. And of course, when he took sannyas, and of course you know that Puja Vachana, Bhakti Vachana, Narayan Narayan. So what is the meaning of Narayan? He's describing that, some Vaishnavas, they were describing that Nar can mean the humans. Nar can mean the humans, and Ayan means the shelter. So shelter of all the human beings. Without thinking that who is he, who is my disciple, who is not my disciple, or where he has come from this country, from India, from abroad, overseas, or whoever approached him, or whoever seemed interested in bhakti, he would adopt him. And then the other meaning of Nar is Ras. Another meaning of Nar is Ras, and Ayan means shelter. Then we see that he, whatever his Harikatha, we would hear that actually he was even, mostly his Harikatha was Ras. Puja Vachala Bhaktivedanta, he is describing that Puja Vachala Bhaktivedanta Padmanabha Maharaj, he was described, he said something very beautiful. He said, I saw that Puja Vachala Bhaktivedanta Padmanabha Swami Maharaj, when he came to the West first, then he established Samadhyan. He established Samadhyan first.
Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Means what relationship we have with the Lord, he established this. And then Puja Vachala Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Maharaj, he established the Abhidhaya, means the process. Mostly you will see scriptures describing the process that we have to adopt. But we see the scriptures and the Harikatha that Gurudev gave us, it is mostly full of Ras. So this was how Padmana Maharaj used to describe it.
What is our aim and object in the Praj Bhakti? You know, so Mahaprabhu Brahmas, one day, only one time he came, only this Braj Bhakti, only this time, only gave this Braj Bhakti. So this is our aim and object. And Gurudev tells, first you can...
First you have to fix your aim and then...
Do any sadhana process. You know? So if going to life and life, no problem, but necessary, only I want this Braj Bhakti, not any else, you know. So Gurudev, this thing, established this thing. So कहते उसका नाम नारायण कहते नारायण का तीसरा अर्थ होता है नर मतलब होता है ज्ञान और आयन मतलब होता है समस्त ज्ञान का जो आश्रय है सचमुच से गुरुदेव का जो ज्ञान है वो अगाध ज्ञान है अक्सर करके हमने जो देखा गुरुदेव को किसी मैठे में आप लोग तो गुरुदेव उसको देखे होंगे सब जानते हो गुरुदेव का शिष्य है अब देखना कोई भी तिथि कुछ आता था गुरुदेव सबको चांस देते थे गुरुदेव क्या करते थे गुरुदेव कहीं नहीं बोलते थे सबको चांस देते थे तुम बोलो तुम बोलो तुम बोलो सबको गुरुदेव चांस देते थे सब बोलने का बाद फिर लास्ट में गुरुदेव फिर बोलते थे लेकिन जब गुरुदेव फिर बोलते थे उसमें नई चीज कोई और गुरुदेव का जो मथुरा में हम लोग देखेंगे गुरुदेव सबको कोशिश करते तुम सीखो तुम हरिकथा तुम सीखो हरिकथा बोलना सीखो गुरुदेव सबको उत्साह गुरुदेव दिया करते थे सबको लेकिन मैंने देखा दूसरे दूसरे गौड़ियों में ये चीज नहीं है क्योंकि वो कोई सोचते हैं अगर ये हरिकथा सीख गया हम ऊपर चला जाएगा फिर हमारा नाम नहीं होगा इसलिए हर गौड़ी मठ जो भी वो टांग पकड़े से खींचते हैं कहते जैसे हमारे ऊपर कोई नहीं चले जाए लेकिन केवल हम महाराज के पास में आकर ये चीज को देखा महाराज जी गुरुदेव सबको चांस देते तुम बोलो तुम बोलो तुम बोलो
वो बोलो जो पिछले वाले ने नहीं बोला
इसलिए हाँ गुरुदेव बोलते पहले वाला का टच नहीं करना नया चीज होनी चाहिए कोई चीज को टच नहीं करनी चाहिए गुरुदेव ऐसे ऐसे गुरुदेव बोलते थे और सबको गुरुदेव चांस दिया करते और लास्ट में गुरुदेव फिर बोलते थे जब बोलते थे एकदम नई बात बोलते थे नई बात इसलिए गुरुदेव के पास में आकर के इतने हरि कथा सीखे इतने गुरुदेव का एक एक से संपूर्ण पृथ्वी में देखो गुरुदेव जब बैठते थे कितने संन्यास वहां पर बैठते थे सब गुरुदेव को देखते थे गुरुदेव मेरे को तो आदेश देते हरि कथा सुनाने के लिए किसी किसी गौड़िया मठ में हम देखा एक व्यक्ति मिलना बहुत कठिन है कोई कथा सुनाने वाला और हमारे मठ में कहते इतने जितने संन्यास देखो
which has not been touched by everybody else. And he was teaching something new, something fresh. So like this, he used to actually teach all his disciples how to speak Harikatha. He would train everybody. He's saying that in other Gaudiya Mathas, I'm saying that there are hardly maybe one speaker, or maybe it's very difficult to find one a proper speaker. But in our mat, he trained so many sannyasis. He trained not only to speak about sannyasis, even some grihasthas, even some ladies. He mentioned so many names that how these are also such wonderful speakers. Whoever came to Gurudev, they became like touchstone. He turned them all to gold. In others, he's saying in other places, hardly one or two speakers. In our temple, even Gurudev used to sit, there used to be so many sannyasis and so many grihasthas who were sitting in front of him, and everybody is looking. Other much maybe one or two speakers, but everybody is looking for a chance. And for maybe weeks and weeks and weeks, although Harikatha is being spoken every day, but somebody will not get a chance. So many speakers we have.
And this is the training and special. Another quality I said to Gurudev, you know, if somebody Gaudiya Mathas, if somebody tried learning something, somebody never gave a chance, so the senior Vaishnava will give. Why?
So that he, why they are not giving, why they are not teaching him? Why somebody prominent speaker will not teach him? He's saying that if I teach him to speak and all, then maybe one day he will become a better speaker than me. So no, there's so much endlessness. But Gurudev, very openly teaching to everybody, come and learn. Whoever is interested in learning, come and learn and speak Harikatha.
I saw Gurudev has some special quality. I saw if somebody is so much interested in learning Harikatha, Gurudev is so much like to him, you know. So much light to Gurudev. So when they came to Gurudev, they are learning so many. When I am staying Mathura, Gurudev every day one slogan he gave to everybody. And next day he is asking. And sometimes he gave one Brahma Sutra, you know, Brahma Tathato, Brahma Jikyasa, Janmandasa. Telling after 7 days, everybody can speak about one Brahma Sutra. So he standing to everybody, you know, stand to everybody. He can speak. So when I came to Mathura temple, that time I completely new, then Gurudev tell you, you can speak Bhaktivinoda Thakura accurately. But oh Gurudev, I have don't know about that time my age, very small age, maybe 20 age, my age. So Gurudev telling this people, Gurudev, I have don't know anything. But like, you following my order, I am following your order. Well, by force, tell you stand up. Gurudev always telling, when you are telling somebody, some Vaishnavas, meaning you gave one flower, his lotus feet, you know. That the lotus feet, one flower. You are remembering it is glory. This way. And one day what happened? Coming to Baladev Vidya Bhusana Prabhu appears today. You know. Then Gurudev, you know, four times when coming somebody appears and disappears yesterday, Gurudev four times he gave class. Many times himself he gave class. 10 o'clock again he sit down, gave class. And afternoon 4 o'clock again Gurudev sit down telling Harikatha. But after Mangala, after Sandhyarati, Gurudev never speaking and he gets chance. You speak. So Baladev Vidya Bhusana Prabhu coming appear today. So Gurudev telling before me, telling 2-3 Vaishnavas you can speak. But always telling you don't touch to any point who is told before, you know. You tell some new points. Already everybody told all points, no any points. So Gurudev asks me, then tell you, Gurudev, I cannot. Then Gurudev gave very big chest right to me, front of everybody. So why you came to temple? You cheating your family, you know? There's some rule, you can serve to father and mother, everybody. But you cheat to them and you came to temple. Why? Bhajan doing bhakti, father doing sleeping and eating only. He came to this temple, Gurudev very big chest right to them. Then when my life completely changed, you know, then when coming, then I am so much afraid. Then coming any Vaishnavas appear to disappear dress, maybe 20 days before I can search him, where is the past time, where is this glorification, you know. This way Gurudev, he tried to everybody be there one day, very good picture and doing bhajan. Because Gurudev Gandhara mein do cheezi dekhne ko milta hai. Isliye Bhagavad Gita mein bataye, acharya kisko kehte hain, acharya usko kehte hain, जो आचरण करे और प्रचार करे, तभी वो आचार हो सकता है। कोई प्रचार करता है, कोई आचरण नहीं करता, कोई आचार करता है, कोई प्रचार नहीं करता। लेकिन गुरुदेव के अंदर में दो गुण पूर्ण रूप में गुरु जी के अंदर में दिखता है। उनका जो आचरण है, इतने स्ट्रांग आचरण गुरुदेव का, इतने स्ट्रांग आचरण गुरुदेव का था, मैं गुरुदेव का कुछ सेवा किया है, गुरुदेव तेल लगाया रहता था,
रात को जब सोते थे तेल लगाते थे गुरुदेव को प्रयाग लगाता था, इसीलिए मैंने देखा गुरुदेव पास में कभी सोया भी पास में तो माधव माध के बाहर गए, मैंने सोया भी गुरुदेव देखा भले ही जितने बजे क्यों नहीं सोए वो उठ जाते हैं ढाई बजे, ढाई तीन बजे गुरुदेव उठ जाएंगे अगर कोई पास में सोए होंगे ना जिसको डिस्टर्ब नहीं करें, डिस्टर्ब नहीं करके खुद जा करके हाथ मुंह धो लेंगे और अपना जब खटिया ऊपर बैठ जाए बैठ करके बोला हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। गुरुदेव जब तक एक लाख हरिनाम को नहीं कर ले तो तुम्हारा कोई नहीं कर पाते हैं। गुरुदेव एक लाख दो लाख रोज हरिनाम करते थे, इनकी साधन इतने स्ट्रांग साधन गुरुदेव का।
He is telling that how in the scriptures it is described that there are
Bhagavad Gita
and Bhagavad Gita it is described that there are a person who is following himself only, there are some people who are following themselves but they are not preaching, and but there are other people who are preaching but not following. So this is not proper. A person should be following himself and that person should be preaching, and that is a proper person. In Gurudev, he said, I have said that.
Yes, this Bhagavad Gita, this slog is telling, Achiroti jaha sastrarte acharya sthapaya tapi swayam acharya jasmat acharya stena kirtita. Telling who is the victim of acharya? Everybody not acharya. Everybody not acharya. Not they are preaching, you know. But telling, that person is the pure acharya here, following also and preaching also.
And then he's saying that I've seen in our Gurudev that how he used to follow and used to preach also. He's saying there were some chances when Madhav Maharaj used to be out of station, then I would have a chance to serve Gurudev closely and then also sleep in the same room as where Gurudev would sleep. He said I would sleep with him and I would understand that how he would, I was sleeping next to him, but he would get up at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the morning, he would get up. And he would, whoever was sleeping next to him, he would not disturb him. He would go there, he would go out, just wash his hands and face, and then would sit down on his cot, and then he would chant his mantra. And before he would not finish one lap, he would not eat breakfast. And for us, to finish 16 rounds, it takes one full day. And that also, maybe sometimes we are not able to chant 16 rounds. And then he would finish one lap before he would have breakfast, and then after breakfast, then again, he would chant one lap throughout the day. So like this, he saw that, I myself saw that, he every day, without fail, sometimes he would sleep very late. Sometimes there was some festival or something in the temple.
Like this, you know, Janmashtami. I saw Janmashtami, maybe you know, 12 o'clock is the Abhishek after 2 prasad, then maybe before 1 you cannot sleep, you know, Janmashtami. I saw when Janmashtami, day of Janmashtami time, Gurudev sleeping maybe 1 o'clock, maybe after, but I saw, you know, even he's sleeping 1 o'clock, after 1 hour, then he wake up. Why, you know, before breakfast, I try to finishing 1 lakh harinam, you know. So, again he wake up, maybe 2 and 2.5, again he can sit up and chanting, you know. Before 9 o'clock, he finishing 1 lakh harinam. Then after also chanting, you know, also chanting 1 lakh. Every day he chanting, two lakh harinam, every day he chanting, two lakh harinam, you know. It is a very great austerity. And the Gurudev sometimes telling, you know, where there was Giridhari Gauri Mat. Before Gurudev also doing bhajan there, Gurudev telling how Al Goswami is doing bhajan. I am trying to do like this bhajan every day, doing Giriraj Parikrama, two lakh harinam, and study Al Goswami's scripture, remembering the slope, you know. I take some Madhuguri friends from Brajavasi's house, and the Gurudev telling how Goswami is there doing bhajan. Once I also tried doing our life bhajan. Isliye Gurudev ka jo sadhan hai, wo to pakka sadhan hai. Isliye itne prachar kaise hua hai Gurudev ji? Itne prachar kaise hua? Karan hai, Prabhupada ji dekho, unhone sat karan naam jagya kiya Prabhupada. Din mein 3 lakh Prabhupada hari naam karte the. Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Goswami Prabhupada, Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj ji ka bhajan kiya hai. Tab bhi inki prachar sara duniya mein inki prachar hua hai. इसलिए आप लोग जितने गुरुदेव का शिष्य है आप लोग बोलो कहते बोलना कि आप लोग गुरुदेव का शिष्य है, इसलिए कोशिश करना कम से कम अपना माला फिक्स राउंड करने के लिए, कम से कम 16 राउंड से तो कभी नीचे नहीं हो, हो तो उसको ऊपर हो, इसलिए महाप्रभु कहते हैं जब तक कोई लखपति नहीं बनेगा उसका हाथ रखा नाम में नहीं खाता, मतलब एक लाख हरिनाम नहीं करेगा तो मैं उसको हाथ खाना। अगर कर तुम अगर एक दिन में एक लखपति नहीं हो सकते, चार दिन में तो तुम सको लखपति बनो, दिन कम से कम बात कर सके कर
He is describing that how Gurudev used to chant 2 lakhs every day and without fail, whatever whatever circumstances, whatever time he is sleeping, he is saying every day he would chant 2 lakhs. He said, and he is saying he had this desire that his disciples also should chant now. He is saying, why did he become such a prominent preacher? He became such a prominent preacher because he performed austerities. He did devote some time in chanting and all. Why did Pujya Srila Bhakti Sansardi Prabhupada became such a prominent preacher? Why did Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, they became such prominent preachers? Because their sadhana was very perfect, their sadhana was very strong. So all of us there have, either there we are direct disciples of Gurudev or we have had so close connection with Gurudev. So he's saying, I'm asking that all of you should adopt all those teachings of Gurudev, all those life habits of Gurudev in your own life. And you should never, you should always have a fixed number of rounds every day, and never you should chant less than 16. As far as possible, you should try be on the other side of 16, means try to chant more than 16.
Mahaprabhu, when Mahaprabhu telling without anybody chanting Vala Harina, I never had to accept anything from you. If you one day, if somebody chanting Vala Harina, meaning you are Lakpati, you know, Lakpati. So telling if you one day not make Lakpati, you can try to 4 days you are becoming Lakpati, you know. Minimum 16 round, not more than a less, you know. Try to anyhow chanting to 16 round anyhow. Why? Then you are disciple of Gurudev. Only take mantra from to Gurudev. This is not enough, you know. This is not enough. Enough is the way you are followed to Gurudev. Then you can perceive you are disciple of Gurudev. Yeah. So, isliye Gurudev ka jo sadhan, ekdam pakka sadhana tha. Sadhana jaise unki bhajan jaise unka acharan jaise. Isliye jo acharan unki itne strong acharan thi. इतने स्ट्रांग गुरुदेव का आचरण, देखो आपका बात कोई आपका शिष्य सुन सकता है लेकिन गुरु भाई आपको बात नहीं सुनेगा, ये मेरा गुरु भाई है। लेकिन गुरुदेव का जो गुरु भाई थे ना, जो सीनियर गुरु भाई थे भक्तिवेदांत तिरुकर गोस्वामी महाराज, बामन गोस्वामी महाराज, तिरुकर गोस्वामी महाराज, देखा जब मथुरा में आते इतना छुप कर जब गुरुदेव नहीं रहते थे उनका चरण पाद का प्रणाम करते थे, चरण पाद का प्रणाम करते थे गुरुदेव का श्रेष्ठ गुरु भाई। और उनका जो गुरु भाई है ना, गुरुदेव को इतने डरते थे, इतने डरते सोच नहीं सकते हो। पंचजन महाराज भी जो आचार्य है गुरुदेव को साष्टांग प्रणाम करते थे। उनका जितने गुरु भाई थे, कारण है, कारण यही है, उनका आचरण भी ठीक था और प्रचार भी ठीक था। उनका आचरण की वजह से सबके सब उनको डरते थे, सबके सब डरते थे, लेकिन आचरण बड़े दृढ़ आचरण गुरुदेव।
Gurudev had very strong acharan. He was describing that all the teachings he used to adopt in his life, and he was following them so strongly. Usually you will see that a person who is preaching, usually he will have his own disciples and they will be his followers and they will listen to his instructions. But to give, to instruct to your own God brothers, it is next to impossible, as we know, next to impossible to preach to your own God brothers and God sisters. But our Gurudev was such a strong person, he was such a strong follower, such a strong follower of all the instructions, that even his own disciples, like our the present Acharya of Devananda Gaudiya Parijat Maharaj, he used to perform sashtanga when he was student. And his other God brothers also. Shila, very prominent, very senior, Pujva Shila Tirukra Maharaj, Pujva Shila Vamanuswami Maharaj. When they would, of course, Gurudev would never let them pay obeisance or pay respects to him in front of him. But I have seen that in a hidden way, they would go and pay sashtanga, then they would pronounce to his Pujva Shila Tirukra Maharaj. Pujva Shila and Vamanuswami Maharaj, they would pay the next to his Padukas.
Tirukra Maharaj.
Oh, sorry. Only Tirukra Goswami Maharaj. He used to pay the numbers to his paduka, his slippers.
Yeah. इसलिए गुरुदेव को जुगाचार के पदवी दी है। जुगाचार के पदवी कौन दिया? बोले साधारण यूनिवर्सिटी नहीं, सारे ब्रजवास मिल करके। आप जाओ ब्रज में जाओ, ब्रज में ना जो बाहर से जो साधु आते हैं उनको कोई रेस्पेक्ट नहीं देते ब्रजवा, तुम क्या हमारा कृष्ण हमारा झूठा गाते हैं, तुम कहाँ से आए इधर उधर। कोई भी ब्रजवासी देखना किसी बाहर से साधुओं को कोई रेस्पेक्ट नहीं देते, लेकिन हमारे महाराज जी को हाँ उसी समय बरसाना में हम लोग ठहरे में था वहां पर जहाँ पर ललिता की गांव है वहां पर बलदेवपुर का स्थान के प्रसिद्ध वहां पर सारे ब्रजवासी आकर के गुरुदेव को युगाचार्य की पदवी दी। सचमुच इसी युग में कली युग में एक विशेष कोई आचार्य है, विशेष एक आचार्य है जिसने संपूर्ण विश्व में महाप्रभु का वाणी प्रचार किया, मिल करके सबके सबको अभिषेक पुष्पों को अभिषेक किया गुरुदेव को, और सारे ब्रजवासी के जितने बड़े बड़े पंडित सब मथुरा के बरसाना के नंदगांव टाकर गुरुदेव को सबके सब मिल करके उन्होंने बहुत बड़ा पदवी युगाचार्य की पदवी दी।
So he is describing that how all the Brajavasis also got together at one time and near Barsana, he is describing that they gave him this title of Yogacharya. He gave him this title. Usually you will see the Brajavasis, they are very proud people. They don't consider anybody to be acharya, they don't consider anybody to be higher than them. They said, what are you preaching? And maybe you are preaching overseas or maybe you are preaching wherever you are preaching, but here we are Brajavasis. Krishna used to eat our remnants. So what we have to learn from you? But these Brajavasis, all the different prominent pandas, prominent pandit scholarly people from Mathura, from Vrindavan and other places in Braj, they gathered together and they gave this title to Gurudev of Yugacharya. Means that he is the acharya of the yuga.
So,
All Hindi Association from Delhi. Also got together to give this.
हाँ इसलिए गुरुदेव की बहुत सारी कथा है, फिर हम लोग शाम को सुनेंगे, अभी हमारे महाराज जी कुछ हरी कथा सुनाएंगे और फिर शाम को सुनेंगे। और एक प्रार्थना है, देखो ये कई युग में भजन करना बहुत कठिन है, इतना आसान नहीं कई युग में कोई भजन कर सकते, इसलिए श्री भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर कहते हैं एकाकी अमार नाही पाए बल हरि नाम संकीर्तन। मतलब है हे प्रभु अकेले भजन करना कलयुग में असंभव है, इसलिए संघे शक्ति संघ में ही शक्ति मिल सकती है। अकेले कोई सोचे नहीं हम घर में अकेले अकेले बैठ कर हरिनाम कर भजन कर ले, नहीं, जब मंदिर छोड़ देते हैं वैष्णव का संघ छोड़ देते हैं मतलब भजन ही छूट गई तुमसे, भजन तुमसे और नहीं हो पाए। इसलिए आप प्रार्थना करके सबको बोलो गुरुदेव कृपा से जो कुछ हो कि मंदिर बना, ठाकुर जी यहाँ पर ठाकुर स्थापन हुए जगन्नाथ जी, कोशिश करे जैसे बीच बीच में जैसे यहाँ पर सप्ताह में जो कीर्तन होता है सत्संग होती है कहीं आप लोग सबके साथ मिले जुले रहो, यहाँ पर थोड़ी कली युग में थोड़ा इधर उधर थोड़ी बहुत होगा, इसलिए इसको ये नहीं करके क्योंकि बड़े भाग्य से कहीं ब्रह्मांड भ्रमण करते करते किसी बड़े भाग्यवान जीव को कहीं सदगुरु की प्राप्ति होती है। हम लोग सबके सब गुरु जी के पास में आए, इसलिए सबके सब मंदिर में आए ठाकुर का दर्शन करे सब मिले जुले रहो, सत्संग में जो यहाँ पर होता है बीच बीच में करो, तभी आपको भक्ति बढ़ी, नहीं तो अकेले भक्ति असंभव करेगी। सबसे प्रार्थना करो, जो महाराज प्रार्थना करते हैं
he's saying, I'm praying, Maharaj is praying to all of you, he's saying that by some design, by some efforts from the devotees in Murilamba, and by the mercy of Gurudev, this temple has come into being. And now I'm requesting all of you that from time to time you should collect together and you should perform Kirtan and Harikatha, you should gather together for Kirtan and Harikatha. He said this is Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, everywhere there will be some disturbances. It's not possible that any situation in any place on this planet will be without any disturbances. So some disturbance, something, it is possible that you may have some conflict, but still you must come here and you must come and gather together. Well, this is Kali Yuga. One more thing in Kali Yuga, that it is not possible that you will perform your bhajan all alone. You may say that, I do not like the situation in the temple, so I stay in the home and I will perform bhajan. If suppose you stop coming to the temple, understand that actually gradually your bhakti will also go away. Remain connected to the temple, remain connected to the devotees. Gurudev Purushottam Sridhar is saying, with folded hands, I'm requesting to everybody who has come here that they should come in Harikatha, they should come in the programs and make this temple alive as far as possible. And also he's saying,
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur telling, Ekaki Amar Nahi Pai Bal Hari Nama Sankirtane Tumi Kripa Kari Sraddha Vidudya Deva Krishna Namdane. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur telling, I am alone.
Now who telling? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, come on, he is telling, oh Prabhu, when I am alone, very difficult to do bhajan, I have no any strength, oh Vaishnava Thakur, kindly wear your own association. Bhaktivinoda Thakur to tell this thing. So tell this Kali Yuga Sanghe Sakti. Then he becoming some strength when we are together. You know, when together. So Mahaprabhu telling Parama Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtana. So Prabhupada in the commentary, what is the meaning of Sankirtana? When it alone, this is the only Kirtan. But this is not a Sankirtana. Sankirtana is there when Bahu Vilitva, when so many devotees together sit down, do Kirtan, then it is Sankirtana. You know, this is the Sankirtana. So you are try to, you know, also she also sometimes give class, and Prabhu also sometimes give class, and some different places going class. Anyhow, you can, where you are like, you can go and listen to Bhagavata. And when temple, some festival, you are trying to come in, maybe week one time, maybe here, Harikatha festival also came to here, and here also different devotee also sometimes, there also give class, you try to come into class, listen to Harikatha, okay? Then your spiritual life, no, increase, fully socially increase. Why this is the Kali Yuga, okay? Now Maharaj, what is sweet something? Also, every time, no? What time? Maharaj, every what time class here?
6.
6 o'clock also, so many devotees coming. That time also, I tell you some new Gurudev past time. Okay?
Gurudev Gaurachandra Harikaya Tadalaye Krishna Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Agyanathinandasya Agyanjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Vetam Jainatasana Shri Gurudevama E Shri Guru Gandhinabhando Svanandatata Karunaika Sindhu Vrindavana Sinaita Vitala Prasidalata Pranakuchara Namaste Gurudevaya Sabasiti Pradayana Savamangalupaya Sabanandavudayane Trasvabho Jagannatha Guru Shamsharavahina Dagdamakuladashtam Chamamsharam Gata Pradasam Samshaktim Sakisandhani Vasanyutam Aham Saktam Vande Shri Guru Rupam Param Sakinya Namo Vishnu Padaya Shri Radhikaya Priyatmane Shri Shrimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Tanamane Yam Prabhajantam Avetya Avetya Kritam Gakmayam Uviraha Katara Juhava Putra Jitamaya Tayatra Bhubine Vistam Savabhutim Vrijamana Goswami Sankashina Karana Tvaya Shai Gavada Shai Chakuyogdi Shai Sheshachai Shamsakals Nityananda Karama Sharanam Namashtu Ajanula Vidabhajo Kanakavarato Sankishnaik Vitro Kamalai Takshu Vishwambaro Dijavaro Jagadama Kalo Vande Jagapriya Karo Karanavitaro Amala Kamala Kanti Nilva Sankshim Shashadara Sanabhaktam Kanjanakshim Manokyam Stani Yugavatam Tidam Adiptam Kishori Vajapati Kantam Radhikam Ashrayam Raja Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasati Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Firstly, I have my Koti Lakshastan Gandhavar pronounced in a Paramaraditam Param Pujipad Nichalila Pravishna Vishnu Pad Paramaksa Srila Gurudev Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. I also offer Koti Lakshastan Gandhavar pronounced to the Lotus Feet of our entire Rupa Nugaya Guru Parampara, especially the Lotus Feet of Srila Gaur Govinda Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhaktivedanta Bhanu Goswami Maharaj, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada, and everyone's our Guru Srila Bhakti Prabhu and Keshava Goswami Maharaj. I also often pronounce again and again the Lotus Feet of Pujipada Bhaktivedanta Srila Maharaj, and pronounce to all devotees assembled, please accept my humble obeisances. Maharaj has ordered me to say a few words, even though I'm not qualified to speak in front of you. But today's the day we know we should do our utmost to glorify our spiritual master and Rupa Nuga Guru Parampara, Vaishnavara Gunagan, Jivara Kuraletan, Sunyachi Sadhguru Mukhe. The sadhus have always explained that the pathway to liberation is to glorify
those enlightened and liberated souls who've already trod the path back to Godhead and are demonstrated as perfect examples of the servant to Godhead and engaged their life in it for the pleasure of the divine couple. So we have to glorify Vaishnavas, and then our key to success is granted by their mercy. So all of us are very fortunate. We've been able to gather today on this auspicious tithi. People have come from so many places. I'm very grateful for you to make the effort and to enhance our happiness on this day, that we're able to remember the lotus feet of our spiritual master. And Maharaj has covered so many nice points of Srila Gurudev's glories. All our lives have been touched by Srila Gurudev, and he's recruited us, all of us, in his transcendental force to spread the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and establish the glories of his spiritual master, Srila Bhakti Prabhu and Keshava Goswami Maharaj, and our entire Upanagar Guru Parampara, strictly in the line of Gaudiya Math Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur Prabhupada, the true embodiment of Rupa Muga Bhajan. Krishna Seva Vasanam, the true mood of serving Krishna is given by our association with these enlightened souls. Shastra says, Acharya Mam Biganiyam, Namam Amitam Parichit, Nama Charbu Disujita, Sabadeva Maya Guru. Sri Krishna himself says to the 11th canto that one should never disrespect the spiritual master. One should understand the Guru is as good as myself, my very self, and one should offer all respects and service to that Guru, and by doing that process, one will be delivered from dosha and material suffering. And more than that, in our line, that Guru will engage us in intimate Nikunja Seva. He'll bring us into the association of Sri Rupa Manjari, Bhati Manjari, all the associates of Srimati Radhika herself, and we'll be able to assist them in their divine loving pastimes. So the good fortune of understanding these things, hearing these things, remembering these things, and glorifying our parampara is without question. It is unfathomable, it is inestimable, it cannot be understood by the rational mind. One only has to surrender one's body, mind, and words in the path of service and surrender, and then the Guru's mercy will come upon our heads. And wherever he's remembered, all the devotees here can become agents of our Gurudev's mercy, and they can go and preach and do their programs and distribute books and enlighten their friends and family members, and that those dust particles of prema, Gurudev used to say that pure devotee will spread that prema dust everywhere. Those particles of pure prema will be spreading also by mercy of devotees under the direct guidance of Srila Gurudev. There's one piece I wanted to read to you by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, so we can remember the position of Sri Gurudeva. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur Prabhupada says, can one worship Krishna without being under the guidance of Sri Guru? Never. Only by getting the favour of the most favoured is it possible to cultivate Krishna consciousness. When one is not under the guidance of the most favoured, one will not find anything favourable for the cultivation of Krishna consciousness or for the pursuit of Krishna's happiness. Our only aim in life is to cultivate Krishna bhakti. This can only be done under the guidance or the instruction of a pure devotee. Sri Vasubhanavi Devi Srimati Radhika is most favoured by Krishna. Worshipping her is most favourable for worshipping Krishna. No one is more favourable than Sri Radha. Those who are very dear to Srimati Radharani are all our spiritual masters in the Rupanuga line. We, the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, are more on the side of Radharani than on the side of Krishna. Indeed, Sri Gurudev is non-different representative of Srimati Radhika Guru Tapa. And he quotes Srila Raghunathdas Goswami, who says, Tambopika Vrishira Vestanayanti Kesi Sevara Karani Guru Nija Paragadme Dasyam Pradaya Guru Mam Raja Kamani Sri Radangri Sevane Rasi Sukhani Shukhado. O Gurudev, you are the beloved Gopika of Srimati Radhika. You can bestow her service, bestowing upon me the shelter of your lotus feet. Kindly make me blissfully engaged within the ocean of the blissful mellows of service to her lotus feet in the kunjas of Braj. And we've heard so many, we all are aware of so many tremendous qualifications of Sri Gurudev. Maharaj explained how Gurudev gave us the proper conception of what is sadhya, what is sadhana, how to fix our goal, how to pursue our life's aim and ambition, which will bring us good fortune, how to associate with Vaishnavas, how to get in the mood of serving superior Vaishnavas so that we can attain their mercy and thereby become pleasing to Krishna. So many wonderful things he gave us. Maharaj is explaining he was always an example of how we should do a Harinam Japa. Gurudev always had his big bag in his hand, and he always followed his sadhana, and he always surrendered himself to his own Gurudev. He made his Gurudev Seva his own life and soul. So in every aspect of Gurudev's life, his perfect character, his perfect behavior, his perfect preaching, his deep, deep ocean of Harikata, he was able to inspire the whole world, and he was awarded the title Yuga Acharya. Very rare indeed. Only one Yuga Acharya has been emerged, and that is Srila Bhaktivinoda Narayana Goswami Maharaj. And the topmost of all these goals that Gurudev has set for us and explained to us how we must behave, he's made it very clear that our goal, our aim and object is Radhika Dasya. We must try and aspire to become Radhika Padi Dasi in the Gana of Lalita Devi, in the Gana of Srimati Radhika, and in the under guidance of Anugatya or Sri Rupa Goswami. And this, by understanding our only aim and object, is to please Srimati Radhika, to become her Dasi. In association under the guidance of our Gurudev, then our life goal will become perfect. Once Srila Gurudev was in Mathura, and one devotee, our Damodara Maharaj, he asked him the question, Gurudev, how can we become like you? How can we follow in your line? And Gurudev said, chant 3 lakhs a day for hundreds of lifetimes, then you can become like me. So we know Gurudev is not an ordinary person, he's coming as a direct Bhakta Avatar, he's a Parikara of the Supreme Lord, and we're fortunate to have met him. Sadhus, I heard some of our Gaudiya Vaishnava sadhus who in other mats, but they're talking about our Gurudev. They said those who had any connection with Gurudev have met him or become the disciple of that personality like Srila Gurudev, their good fortune is inconceivable. We cannot measure that good fortune. So to tolerate Gurudev said, follow the three C's, don't complain, don't criticize, and always chant. We just stay on the bus. We don't get on the Trump train, but we're getting on the Gurudev's bus. And we're going on Parikram with Srila Gurudev. And we're trying to offer ourselves to Srila Gurudev every day and do what we can to take care of each other, be kind to each other, and build up our Sangha. Think of the next generation. Gurudev told me personally so many times, I want a school in Murulambay. I'm asking all of you to help. Please establish one school here. We can bring a Sanskrit teacher from India, and we can teach the next generation how to be saved from this hellish ocean of Kali Yuga, which is enveloping and devouring all. Kale Dosheni De Rajan, Yasti Ikan Mahaguna, Kirtanari Vakrishna Sya, Muktasanga Paramajit. So Gurudev's mercy is very vast. We offer our Pushpanjali to him again and again, and to all his associates, and we pray for his mercy on all of us today. And I especially offer my thanks to our Pujapati, Sridhar Maharaj, for giving us a chance to come together today and offer up renounce to our Gurudev. Manchi Kapa to his child, Kripa Sankhya Gurudev, Chala, Kripa Kapa, Nibya, Vaishnava, Vyavu, Nama, Vyavu, Nama, Vyavu, Nama, Vyavu, Nama, Vyavu, Nama,
Vyavu,
Evening time, all Gurudev disciples who the one speaking, everybody can speak to glory of Gurudev. Okay? Evening time, try to come to
everybody. Hare Krishna. Everybody stand here. Now you are doing Guru Puja.
आरती कौन करेगा? तुम्हें आरती करोगे?